Hello, 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 hello. Welcome to this new updated
Welcome.
session. I hope you all are able to listen to me, see me for this session of the updated chanting taken by our beloved Paras. Paras कहाँ है भाई? शिबो? Paras कहाँ भाई? ओ भाई किधर है?
आ रहा हूँ सर,
ये क्या कर रहा है
खेल
भाई?
रहा हूँ थोड़ा सा, क्योंकि
ये क्या मजा आ
चैटिंग
गया
से पहले थोड़ा फ्रेश हो जाऊं, मूड
अबे?
सही हो जाएगा, लेने मजा आएगा
यहाँ बच्चों की फटी पड़ी है, तू कौन सी बॉल घुमा रहा है? यहाँ बच्चों के
क्या
बॉल
बात कर रहे हो,
मुंह में आ गए हैं इनके बॉल
आगे गए ये लोग वापस
और
आ गए
क्या
क्या?
और क्या
वाओ, सो गुड टू सी यू ऑल। हेलो 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 हेलो,
हेलो हेलो हेलो
क्या बात है, वाह वाह वाह। वेलकम ऑल टू दिस हाइब्रिड चैंटिंग सेशन ऑफ एफएमजी एंड नीट पीजी। यस माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे
यस
इन 2 आवर्स वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट ऑल ऑफ द ऑर्थोपेडिक्स। हेलो टू ऑल ऑफ यू, 340 आर लाइव, सो गुड टू सी यू, लव यू।
यस
एंड बिफोर स्टार्टिंग ईच एंड एवरी सेशन, आर टैग लाइन क्या है दोस्तों? आई विल पास,
पास
आई
आई विल
विल पास,
पास
आई
आई विल
विल पास,
पास
आई विल पास। माय गॉड माय गॉड, एक बार सुनना है
क्या
भाई हमें, हमें जोरदार सुनना
यस
है, बड़ा मन हो रहा है बहुत दिनों के सुने हुए। सो गुड टू सी यू ऑल बैक ऑन यूट्यूब। माय गॉड, 426 आर लाइव, लव
वाह,
यू।
वेरी
तो एक
गुड,
बार बोल दो सारे लोग, आई विल पास,
पास
आई विल पास,
पास
आई विल।
पास, क्या
क्या
बात
बात
है
है क्या बात है। इन 2 to 3 मिनट्स वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद आर सेशन। मैं थोड़ा और खेल लेता हूँ सर,
अबे।
मजा आ रहा है।
बट व्हाई यू आर प्लेइंग अलोन?
सर आई एम अलोन ओनली, ओके, आई लव टू लिव अलोन, है ना? थोड़ा एनर्जी बची रहती है सर, है
वाह
ना? तो वो एनर्जी मैं चैंटिंग में खर्च करना चाहता हूँ, मैं इनको सबको पास कराना चाहता हूँ। मजा आ गया,
यस,
कौन कौन खेलना चाहता है?
दे कैन
क्या
ऑल
बात है
कम,
क्या बात है।
दे कैन ऑल
दे कैन ऑल, वाह वाह
कम।
वाह वाह
यस,
वाह, क्या बात
आई होप यू ऑल आर लिसनिंग टू अस एंड यू आर ऑल मोटिवेटेड। यू आर हैविंग दिस सेशन फ्रॉम अवर न्यू स्टूडियो।
यप,
यस, ऑल थैंक्स टू योर, व्हाट यू से, ब्लेसिंग्स, योर
ब्लेसिंग्स
सपोर्ट
एंड
एंड द
एवरीथिंग।
एडमिशंस यू
यस
पीपल गेव बाय रेफर्ड और योर सेल्फ टेकन। वी
हाँ,
गॉट सम मनी, 521 लाइव,
यप
so we got
यप
some money
यप
and this
यप सर,
money provided us to have the wireless mic, so
यस,
now we both can stand see,
स्टैंड, डांस,
otherwise
स्टेज,
we only
एवरीथिंग।
have
दिस
to
सेशंस आर
share
गोइंग टू बी
one
रॉकिंग
mic, so we
सेशन।
are
डन
having,
डन,
yes, so we can even play,
कैन यू टेक बॉल सर? यस
take two balls, this is a
क्या
very
बात है, यस,
so
सो गुड
these
टू सी
are
यू,
our good
सो गुड टू
session,
सी
we
यू,
are happy.
वाह। एंड आई एम वेरी मच थैंकफुल टू डॉक्टर नितिन भगत, विच इज एनएलसी ऑर्थो फैकल्टी,
यस
हुज नोट्स आई एम फॉलोइंग टुडे। वी आर वेरी थैंकफुल टू आर फैकल्टी डॉक्टर नितिन भगत सर, ही इज वॉचिंग मी, हेलो टू सर। सो
यस
गाइज आर यू रेडी फॉर द सेशन? जल्दी से एक थम्स अप दे दो, विल स्टार्ट, विल स्टार्ट,
यस यस
जल्दी से एक थम्स अप दे दो। आर वी रेडी, आर वी रेडी? ऐसे भी करते हैं ना सर, ऐसे करके फिर ऐसे टांगों के बीच से, है ना?
ताऊ के बीच में बहुत कुछ होता
आई डोंट नो
है।
सर, आर वी रेडी? क्या बात है क्या बात है क्या बात है।
So I
सो
think
गाइज
you start.
वी आर रेडी, यस वी आर रेडी। सो गाइज लेट्स स्टार्ट विद अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म्स इन द ऑर्थोपेडिक्स। नंबर
Yes.
वन थिंग इज यू हैव टू लर्न अबाउट द पेरियोस्टियम। यस माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, नंबर वन थिंग यू हैव टू लर्न अबाउट द पेरियोस्टियम। वेयर
Yes.
इज पेरियोस्टियम एक्चुअली? लेट मी ड्रॉ बोन। एंड गाइस रिमेंबर, दिस बोन इज नाउ कवर्ड बाय सम लेयर। दिस लेयर इज नोन एज पेरियोस्टियम। सो व्हाट इज रिटन इन द डेफिनेशन, ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, आउटर कवरिंग ऑफ द बोन, आउटर कवरिंग ऑफ द बोन इज नोन एज। नंबर वन एमसीक्यू फॉर यू गाइस, आउटर कवरिंग ऑफ द बोन इज नोन एज। प्लीज स्टे एक्टिव इन द चैट बॉक्स, आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग योर आंसर बिकॉज दिस इज यू हु आर गोइंग टू राइट एग्जाम ऑन 4th ऑफ जून, एंड ऑल्सो माई डियर फ्रेंड्स हु इज राइटिंग नीट पीजी एग्जाम अलॉन्ग विद मी। यस, सो वॉट पेरियोस्टियम एक्चुअली डूज गाइज, रिमेंबर इट प्रोटेक्ट्स अगेंस्ट द ट्यूमर एंड
Yes.
इन्फेक्शन।
Wow.
It protects against the tumor and infection. Guys, remember which collagen is present over here? Always remember type 1. Type 1 collagen is present. In the cartilage, which collagen is present? Type 2 collagen. In the bones, which collagen is present? Always remember it is type 1 collagen. Guys, this is your PYQ. This is your PYQ of FMG. Yes. You can't forget this thing. This is very, very important. Sharpest fiber.
Yes.
Let me show you where are they actually. This is my diagram of bone. And you have to remember this orange wala part. Ye santri rang. Santro se kya kya yaad aata hai tumhe? Guys, remember that space between the bone and the periosteum is actually covered by Sharpe's fiber, Sharpe's membrane. This membrane is actually connecting the bone with the periosteum. This was the exam question. And how it was asked, let me tell you. The question was asked, what is the structure which is connecting a bone with the periosteum? What is your answer? Please write the answer in the chat box. This was a simple question, has been asked in the FMG exam. Please, can you tell me which one is the answer? Yes, my dear friends, your great answer is Sharpe's fiber. That is your Sharpe's fiber. Yes. Two terms are very much crystal clear to you guys. Next term is 100% MCQ. 100% MCQ matlab guarantee 100% MCQ. Even it is asked in the NEET PG exam also, in FMG exam also, 4 to 5 times.
Yes.
Osteomalacia. The main cause is vitamin D deficiency. Vitamin D deficiency is the main cause, and what is present over there? There is a softening of bone due to decrease in the minerals. Guys, remember, there is a softening of bone due to decrease in minerals. And there is a very, very, very important keyword present over here. You all have to remember, that is your loser's zone. Guys, remember, that is your loser's zone which is present, and you can easily see this on your x-ray.
642, right?
Oh my God. Oh my God. This is a normal part of the bone. This is a normal side. And this here you can appreciate. Can you appreciate this thing? There is one line present over there which is actually looking like a fracture, but in the main content it is not a fracture. That is your loser's zone. That is your loser's zone. And my question to you, loser's zone is seen in which disease? You have to answer. Loser's zone is seen in which disease? My dear friends, you have to answer in the chat box right now, because it is your exam after 70 to 75 days. Please. That is your osteomalacia. Osteomalacia. And remember, the keyword over here is volume of bone is normal. Yes, my dear friends, the volume of bone is normal. How the patient would be coming to you? How the patient would be coming to you? Remember, patient would be telling you, doctor sahab, haddiyon mein dard ho rahi hai aur muscle mein bhi dard ho rahi hai. Bone pain and muscle weakness. So this is all about the osteomalacia. And easily solve your MCQ. Fourth term we have to remember here is of osteoporosis. Word porosis itself is telling you that there are pores. Means your bone is now khokha andar se. It is very much vacant. It is very much empty from our inside. This is actually porous bone. That is actually porous bone, and porous things are easily breakable. Jo log andar se khokhle hote hain wo bahut jaldi toot jate hain dosto, isliye majbooti andar se lani hai. Yes, my dear friends, are you ready? Are you ready for the 4th June exam? Are you promising us that you will work day and night? And we promise you to work with you day and night. Love you, love you, love you. Bone is porous and can break easily. Second MCQ, what can be asked in this is most common cause of pathological fracture. Can't forget this. Guys, remember, in MCQ, this would be asked, what is the most common pathological cause of fracture? What is your answer? Can you tell me answer in chat box, my dear friends?
Type it.
I'm expecting answer. That is your osteoporosis. Osteoporosis. Ab aage. ये बताओ, लड़कों के पास मछली कहां पे होती है? सर, आपको पता है लड़कों के पास मछली होती है कहां होती है? ट्राइसेप्स में होती है? नहीं, एक ऑर्गन होती है, जब हम उसको रिट्रैक्ट करते हैं, परप्यूज को रिट्रैक्ट करते हैं, तो दैट अपीयरेंस लुक लाइक फिश माउथ. यस और नो? तो मछली वाले कौन कौन है भाई? मछली वाले कौन कौन है? क्या बोलते हैं, मछली जल की रानी है, जीवन उसका पानी है, हाथ लगाओ क्या हो जाएगा सर,
मर जाएगी,
बाहर निकालो तो मछली को बाहर नहीं निकालना अंदर ही रखना है। बिल्कुल बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, ठीक है, समझ दोस्तों किस मछली की बात कर रहा हूं मैं। मेल फ्रेंड्स कैन रिलेट इट वेरी मच। तो ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस के अंदर एक मछली है, एंड गाइस एग्जाम क्वेश्चन दिस वाज, दिस एक्सरे वाज आस्क्ड एंड दे आस्क्ड कॉड फिश और फिश माउथ वर्टिब्राइ सीन इन, व्हाट इज योर आंसर आफ्टर दिस चैटिंग माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, बताओ जल्दी क्या आंसर दोगे, व्हाट इज योर, दिस इज फिश और फिश माउथ वर्टिब्रा, मछली का मुंह खुल गया है, बिल्कुल मछली का मुंह खुल गया है, अब मछली फिश जो है पाउच करती है, ऑल द पाउट क्यूइंग्स इन आवर चैट, सैल्यूट टू यू एंड थैंकफुल टू यू, बिकॉज ऑफ यू वी आर गेटिंग 1 marks इन FMG एंड नीट PG एग्जाम। यस माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, यस यस यस, तो ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस, माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन टू यू, व्हाट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन पैथोलॉजिकल कॉज ऑफ फ्रैक्चर, व्हाट इज योर आंसर, यस योर आंसर इज ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस। देन माय नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज फिश माउथ और फिश माउथ वर्टिब्रा और कॉड फिश वर्टिब्रा इज सीन इन, योर आंसर इज ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस, ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस। नेक्स्ट डिजीज इज ऑस्टियोपेट्रोसिस, ऑस्टियोपेट्रोसिस, फर्स्ट वी स्टडी इज ऑस्टियोपोरोसिस, नाउ petrosis, this is also known by a very hi-fi term which is known as marble bone disease, that is known as marble bone disease, marble bone disease, ठीक है, we are working on this, no worries, no worries, no worries, अगर तुम साथ हो, अगर तुम साथ हो तो चिंता की क्या बात है, हंसते हंसते गाते गाते हम याद करेंगे orthopedics, what is happening here, abnormal increase in bone density. Guys, remember, you should always be balanced in your life. If you are increasing your density, that is also bad. If you are decreasing your density, that is also bad. As you seen in the case of osteoporosis. Now, petrosis, what is happening? Old bone is not removed because osteoclasts are less, but the new bone formation is continuously happening. And because of the continuous new bone formation on the old bone, it actually look more dense, more white, actually look like a marble, that is known as osteopetrosis. कैसे relate कर सकते हैं सर हम इसे?
किसको?
इस osteoporosis, petrosis को.
बता बता.
पुराना जो बंदा था,
हाँ.
वो तो गया नहीं.
अच्छा तो
कौन? नए नए बनाते रहे, बनाते रहे, बनाते रहे.
Okay.
है ना? और नए नए बनाते रहे और फिर एकदम से दिल टूट गया. तो क्या बोलते हैं? शीशे का था दिल मेरा, पत्थर का जमाना था, ओ दिल टूट गया, ओ दिल टूट गया, क्या बात है दोस्तों, क्या बात है, एंड इट कैन इजिली गेट फ्रैक्चर, हाउ इट इज फ्रैक्चर राइट नाउ आई हैव एक्सप्लेन, लेट मी टेल यू अबाउट द हेल्दी बोन एंड ऑस्टियोपेट्रोसिस, व्हाट अपीयरेंस यू आर गोइंग टू सी इन, गाइस रिमेंबर, नाउ दिस वन इज योर हेल्दी बोन, कैन यू रिलेट, ऑल द कॉर्टेक्स, इट इज इजिली विजिबल, ऑल बोन इज वेरी मच dense, hypodensity, everything is visible and you can relate it with the normal bone. But on the other hand, you can see all the bone is now dense, hyperdense, it's all calcified because of new bone formation, over calcification that is actually looking like a marble, and this, with this x-ray, if it's going to come in your exam,
yes.
Itna bada case hoga, itna bada. कितना बड़ा, इतना बड़ा केस होगा और उसके साथ इतनी सी इमेज होगी, तो इतने बड़े से डरने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है, क्योंकि हमें पढ़ाया गया है जब हमें ऐसी इमेज दिखेगी और लास्ट लाइन में लिखा होगा डायग्नोसिस देखना है, तो व्हाट वी हैव टू से, ऑस्टियोपेट्रोसिस, मार्बल बोन डिजीज, डन डना डन, डन डना डन, माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, 200% MCQ, 200% MCQ लिख लो, गारंटी ले लो, 200% MCQ each and every exam this question has been asked, even in the NEET PG this question has been asked,
yes.
Osteogenesis imperfecta,
yes.
This way, इतना ही बड़ा केस था, इतना बस, नहीं डरना इतने बड़े केस से,
नहीं
डरना, just you have to think what, number one feature, hearing loss, और कौन सा वाला, sensorineural hearing loss, number two, ब्लू स्क्लेरा, Yes. And number three is multiple fracture. Wow. More than enough to solve the case of osteogenesis imperfecta. आज तक इस सवाल को घुमा फिरा के किसी ने नहीं दिया है. And in the near future, on the fourth, this question would be on your screen. Mark yes. my word, on your screen. Yes. So what is a triad? Can you all write down in the chat box, what is a triad for osteogenesis imperfecta, my dear friends? Number one is, hearing loss. Number two, blue sclera. And in the bones, there is multiple fracture. In bones, there is multiple fracture. Osteogenesis.
Normally, eyes kya honi chahiye? Eyes blue. इसकी उल्टी है.
Yes.
इसका sclera is blue.
Sclera is
that blue. Is reverse. Yes. Imperfect
but eyes. Blue eyes, I have seen somewhere, sir.
Maybe Russia, Ukraine.
Blue eyes hypnotized teri kar diye mainu. But yahan pe blue eyes deti hai. Ek number.
Yes. Blue.
FMG and Neet PG exam.
Yes.
Next is also 100% MCQ. Guys, this question is. Now, this orthopedic node is very much related with our which subject? Can you guess the subject? Radiology. Yes, wow. My dear friend. Radiology. Poll pe jo question aa raha hai, I want all of you to answer.
Yes.
We are thankful to Dr. Ritesh Raja who is continuously yes. posting the question on the poll. You all have to answer and mark my word. Aaj 4 se 5 number leke jaane. Are you all ready?
700.
क्या तुम लोग ready हो आज 4 से 5 नंबर बटोरने के लिए? Yes.
700.
क्या बात है?
700.
सात समंदर और 700 पे सातवीं टर्म. आज की सातवीं टर्म हमारी Paget disease of bone. A disease that disturbs the replacement of old bone with the new bone. Again, girlfriend boyfriend concept. सर क्या होता है? देखो. ये क्या कहता है डिस्टर्ब द रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ ओल्ड बोन विद द न्यू बोन. ठीक है ये पुराना वाला जो बॉयफ्रेंड बेचारा या गर्लफ्रेंड जो कॉलेज में थी ठीक है अब उसको भगाना है और इसके बदले में नया वाला वर्जन लेके आना है जो अच्छा वाला है. ठीक है जो इंडिया आने के बाद बनेगा बट उन्होंने उम्मीद तो करी कि ये अच्छा वाला होगा बट जो नया वाला आया वो उसने तो चरस बो के रख दी उसने खराब कर दी. नया बोन जो आना था पुराने के बदले वो और भी ज्यादा खराब निकला. दिस डिजीज इज नोन एज पैगेस डिजीज ऑफ बोन. तो पुराना या कि नया वाला लाना है
दोनों ट्राई करना चाहिए.
It's okay, life is too short. On x-ray, guys, this question has been repeated multiple time. Let me tell you, cotton wool skull appearance yes. seen in. My question to you guys, cotton wool skull appearance is seen in. Jaldi se. Cotton wool skull appearance is seen in. What is your answer? Please write in the chat box very quickly. I want all of you to be active throughout this session to gain maximum knowledge in just 2 hours. Now, there are three stages. Yes, my dear, there are three stages of Paget's disease. Number one is lytic stage. What lytic itself says what? Breakdown. Guys, remember,
पहले काटेगा.
बिल्कुल. Bone breaks only. ये काटो वर्ड सुनते ही आपकी रिफ्लेक्स एकदम कैसे एक्टिवेट होगी? क्या आपका बहुत ज्यादा कटा है कि कभी नहीं कटा है?
बहुत ज्यादा. अब तो छोटा सा रह गया.
Next is your mixed stage. Mixed stage में what is happening? Bone breakdown and formation.
Yes.
पुराना वाला कट रहा है, नया वाला आ रहा है. Sclerotic stage, only bone formation. सिर्फ नया वाला है, only yes. bone. Now my question to you guys is, cotton wool skull is seen in which stage of Paget's disease? Yes. What is your answer? Answer is right on this screen. Guys, remember that is none other than your mixed stage. Yes. Mixed stage of Paget's disease, you will see cotton wool skull. You will see cotton wool skull. Done. Achondroplasia, 100% MCQ.
Yes.
Champion kis ko pasand hai? Mere dosto, jaldi se batao. Champion kis ko pasand hai? Toh kya kehte hai? अभी जिंदा हूं तो पी लेने दो बरी बरसात में जी लेने दो. जल्दी से बता दो दोस्तों, शैंपेन किस किस को पसंद है? हाँ जी, यहां जल्दी से क्या स्क्रीनशॉट
इनके पेरेंट्स को भेजा जाए, ये क्या चाहते हैं जल्दी से कर दो सर, स्क्रीनशॉट ले लो जल्दी, इनके पेरेंट्स को भेजना, इससे पहले ये
लिया है सब बच्चों के,
इससे पहले ये डिलीट कर दे, मुझे इनका स्क्रीनशॉट चाहिए भाई, बिल्कुल बिल्कुल। So guys, remember most common cause of dwarfism. Achondroplasia, say you have to remember. Have you all watched a very famous TV series, Goat? Game of Thrones. Have you all watched? And in that Game of Thrones, एक छोटा सा बंदा था सर, उसका नाम था टीरियन लैनिस्टर। सर मैंने जैसे ही उसको देखा, वो इतना सा बंदा, उसके आसपास चार चार लड़कियां, कसम से किसी को वो सीन याद, डिस्ट्रैक्ट मत होना, 4 जून को एग्जाम है, समझ में आया? ऑफिस मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज ऑफ डॉर्फिज्म, मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज ऑफ डॉर्फिज्म, ठीक है। चलो इसमें उसका अपीयरेंस याद करो, एक बार अपीयरेंस याद करो प्लीज प्लीज प्लीज। आओ टीरियन लैनिस्टर को याद करते हैं, ट्रंक इज नॉर्मल, उसका ट्रंक कैसा था, नॉर्मल था, बट जो लिम्स थे, बट जो क्या थे, लिम्स थे, दोज वर शॉर्ट। तो सर लिम्ब शॉर्ट थे बट लिंग शॉर्ट नहीं था, उसके लिम शॉर्ट थे, लिंग शॉर्ट नहीं था, इसलिए चार चार थी, समझ में आ गया। तो ट्रंक इज नॉर्मल बट द लिम्स आर शॉर्ट, एंड इन दिस बेबी व्हिच हैंड्स आर, कैन यू टेल मी दिस, देयर इज अ डिफरेंस, देयर इज अ डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द टू फिंगर्स, द मिडल फिंगर एंड द रिंग फिंगर, दिस हैंड इज नोन एज ट्राइडेंट हैंड एंड इट इज रिजेंबलिंग अ स्टार फिश, इट इज रिजेंबलिंग अ स्टार फिश। वेन एवर देर इज अ एमसीक्यू एंड इट इज गिवन इन द केस, देर इज अ ट्राइडेंट हैंड सीन, विच डिजीज यू विल बी रिमेंबरिंग फ्रॉम दैट, विच डिजीज यू विल बी रिमेंबरिंग फ्रॉम दैट, योर आंसर इज एकांड्रोप्लेशिया, स्टार फिश लाइक हैंड, स्टार फिश लाइक। कैन यू टेल मी विच अपेयर seen without even teaching, can you tell me which appearance is seen, which appearance is seen, can you tell me, ye dekho ye, which appearance is seen, can you all tell me which appearance is seen, I want to see which appearance is seen, my dear friends, which appearance is seen, yes you all are correct, you all are correct, this is champagne glass appearance, and remember this was neat pg exam question and also fmg exam question, itta bada case diya tha, itta bada। Yes. उसके नीचे ये इमेज दे रखी थी और डायग्नोसिस पूछा था, तो हमारे हमारे धुआंदार धुआंदार मेडिकोस क्या आंसर करेंगे, व्हाट यू विल आंसर, प्लीज टेल मी व्हाट यू विल आंसर, स्ट्रेट अवे योर डायग्नोसिस इज एकांड्रोप्लेशिया, एकांड्रोप्लेशिया, परफेक्ट 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 परफेक्ट, लव यू ऑल, लव यू ऑल। द 9th टर्म वी हैव टू रिमेंबर इज ऑस्टियोमेलाइटिस, ऑस्टियोमेलाइटिस हैज बीन आस्क्ड इन द एग्जाम मल्टीपल टाइम, दैट इज व्हाई these topics are very high yield and very very important, without knowing these topic you can't even enter the exam, so must watch this all video thoroughly, twice thrice, okay? Infection of the bone, osteomyelitis is actually the infection and the inflammation, because of infection there is an inflammation, there is an infection of bone, and my first question to you, most common organism responsible for this, for osteomyelitis, guys remember osteomyelitis, the most common organism responsible is staph aureus, that is your staph aureus, and what is the most common root, hematogenous, guys two questions you have to remember here, number one thing is most common organism, your answer is staph aureus, and what is the root spread, your answer is hematogenous,
yes,
osteomyelitis is of question has been asked from this also, acute and chronic, acute and chronic, sudden onset is acute and the long term is a chronic, long term is a, okay done. Now who are cute, who
are, sir will say children's,
mujhe pata hai aapki gandi buddhi mein kya aaya hoga aur in bachchon ko bhi pata hai, theek hai dosto। Now, acute osteomyelitis is most commonly seen in, my dear friends, the question for you is acute osteomyelitis seen in, most commonly seen in children's, because बच्चे होते हैं cute, इसीलिए acute वाले में cute बच्चे, ठीक है। Common site is metaphysis, and why metaphysis, the reason is very much clear, because that is most vascular part, and before this we studied spread is most common for the osteomyelitis, your answer is hematogenous, that is why metaphysis is the first place in osteomyelitis, which is affected by an organism known as staph aureus. That is known as staph aureus. Audio is lagging. Okay. Now it is fine. My dear people out there, is this fine? Now, awaaz nahi aa rahi clear. Yeah, now it is fine. It's good now. It is good now. Because of my movement, I think it is happening because of overactivity. See you guys after so long is making me so excited that my voice is lagging. Perfect. Now it is fine. Chalo, I'll try to move less. Okay. Osteomyelitis, number one thing I was telling is, let me repeat for you guys, it is infection of bone, and most common organism is staph aureus. Number second question, number third is, most common is hematogenous spread. Which spread is most common? That is hematogenous spread. And in children, acute osteomyelitis is most commonly seen in children. And which part is affected more? That is your metaphysis. Why metaphysis? Because metaphysis is most vascular part. Now, chronic osteomyelitis has been asked in the exam. And what exact question was asked? I will tell you that only. Hallmark is sequestrum. What is sequestrum? Whenever the word sequestrum is coming, the first thing in your mind should come is chronic osteomyelitis, and sequestrum is known as dead bone. It is known as dead bone present in chronic osteomyelitis. This is actually sequestrum, which is seen in chronic osteomyelitis. And the most common organism responsible for osteomyelitis is your staph aureus. Most common spread is hematogenous root, which is the most common structure which is involved, that is your metaphysis. Next, MCI ka FMG recall question, involucrum. The question was given, involucrum is seen in. Actually, the question was asked in two ways. It was asked, the new bone formation in the chronic osteomyelitis is known as, what is your answer? It is known as involucrum. The new bone formation, you can appreciate the little bone coming out from the edge. This is known as involucrum. Sequestrum is a dead bone in chronic osteomyelitis, and involucrum is a new bone formation in the chronic osteomyelitis. That is the new bone formation in the chronic osteomyelitis. Done? Are we clear? Are we crystal clear? I want thumbs up from all of you in the chat box. Are we all clear till this? Shall we move forward? Yes or please answer, my dear friends, please answer. All of to stay active. Yes. Aage bade chale. Veer tum bade chalo dheer pahad ho singh ki dahad ho tum nidar bade chalo tum nidar date raho veer tum bade chalo dheer tum bade chalo. Kya baat hai? Next MCQ in the exam, that is none other than Brodie's, and most common organism again is staph aureus. To osteomyelitis, what is most common organism? What's your answer, my? What is your answer? Please tell me. What is your answer? Perfect. That is your staph aureus. Brodie's abscess, what is happening? Bone is now replaced by a pus, and that pus is actually created by an organism known as staph aureus. In this image, you can see a pus always looks black. In the x-rays, if we see pus, that will liquid, it will look black. Here is a black structure which is actually replaced, a bone replaced by a pus, and the most common organism responsible is staph aureus. I think a voice is now fine. It is a left. Okay, no problem. Fine now. Is this fine? Hello. Should I sit and take like?
We'll try. Otherwise, we'll put that other mic.
Okay. Very sorry. I'm very sorry for the lag.
Okay.
Still, there is a lag and.
Shibu.
No lag.
चलो जल्दी से बताओ जल्दी से. वॉइस इज कमिंग. वॉइस इज देयर और नॉट. नाउ नाउ इट विल कम. नाउ इट विल कम. इट वॉज ऑफ फ्रॉम माय साइड. प्लीज प्लीज प्लीज. वॉइस इज कमिंग. वॉइस इज कमिंग. या इट्स कमिंग नाउ. प्लीज. वॉइस इज कमिंग. यस आवाज आ गई. Can you please project my iPad? Okay. Nice, fine. Nice. I'm very sorry. I'm very sorry. ठीक है. सही है. थोड़ा सा मेडिको बंदे हैं ना. टेक्निकल काम कम आते हैं. थोड़ा समझ आता है. चल. फोकस. A thumbs up from you all. Are we focused to start the next topic? I think voice is clear from my side. Echo is coming. Is it fine? Echo is there. Some people are saying echo. Okay. Let just 2 minutes. Just give me 2 minutes and I'll make sure that everything is fine. Everything is fine. Everything is fine. Okay, we are working on that. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for being here. So nice of you. So good of you people. All good. Bathroom effect आ रहा है तो ये एक chanting है. Bathroom chanting. Is this fine now?
Song. Okay. Let's start song. Echo baby.
Speak normally. It's fine now. Yeah. It's fine now. चल. Please project the iPad. Projection is not. It's not there. Okay, are we ready to start? Are we ready, my dear friends? Are we ready? Okay, are we ready? Yes. Yes, we are ready. No, not a problem. Okay. Next thing is your ankylosing spondylitis. 100% MCQ in the exam. Ankylosing spondylitis, remember, an inflammatory arthritis which is affecting the spine and the large joint. Let me talk about this disease, how it is affecting. There is a joint space. Let's suppose I'm talking about the vertebra. Yes. There's a joint space between two vertebras. In this disease, what is happening? Decreasing of joint space because of inflammation.
Yes.
Now the joints are fusing with each other. We can easily see in this image. Can you appreciate a normal joint space present over here? Okay, this is a normal joint space. Okay, this is a normal joint space, and ankylosing spondylitis, there is a decrease in joint space. And remember, guys, remember. Should I keep it here and try? And remember, guys, remember. Voice is very heavy. Okay. Now, ankylosing spondylitis on X-ray. On X-ray, it will show us bamboo spine appearance. Fused spine will see on X-ray, and it will actually show us bamboo spine appearance. My dear friends, which bamboo spine? Bamboo spine. On X-ray, it will show us. Okay, let's focus. On X-ray, you will see fused spine, and it will look like bamboo spine. So my question to you, What is your answer? Bamboo spine appearance is seen in. Your answer is ankylosing spondylitis. My next question to you guys, which has been asked in the exam, guys, remember, gene involved is HLA-B27. Your question on the board is right here, and this is actually previous year question of FMG. Guys, remember, which gene is involved in ankylosing spondylitis? Your answer is HLA-B27. HLA-B27 is a perfect answer. You all are very much correct, and I assure you a guarantee, on 4th of June, you all are going to pass. I can see your answers, your quick response, your love for learning. You guys are going to pass on 4th of June. Yes, my dear friends. Let's talk about the bursitis. Bursitis. I know for the people of UP, this word is very much vulgar, but vulgarity always comes with a 1 marks. Do we need one mark? Yes or no? Please answer me. Do we need 1 mark? Yes. Agar vulgarity se hamara ek number aata hai, should we go for the vulgarity or not? I want you guys to answer on the live chat right now. 730 people are watching, and I want answer from each one of you. Yes. हाँ भाई, हम वल्गर हैं, बदले में हम नॉलेज गेन करते हैं, गंदी बातों से ज्ञान निकालते हैं, उस ज्ञान से पास हो जाते हैं, और नित प्रतिदिन बोलते हैं आई विल पास. ठीक है, चलो. माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, इंफ्लेमेशन ऑफ फ्लूइड फिल्ड पैड, एक्चुअली बिटवीन द टू बोन्स देयर आर फ्लूइड फिल्ड पैड्स व्हिच आर एक्चुअली प्रिवेंटिंग दोस बोन्स from the friction. In the old age, what is happening, those pads are gone, and the two bones are having friction with each other, and the old people are generally complaining of pain in the joint because of loss of bursa, and this will actually lead to inflammation. This is known as bursitis. Let's learn, and one more question has been asked from this bursitis. Okay, chalo. Let's learn. Housemaid's knee, which bursitis is seen? You all have to answer in the chat box. Let's learn. I will speak, you will write, and we are going to learn. Housemaid's knee, which bursitis is seen? Yes, my dear friends, you all are correct. Pre-patellar bursitis. Housemaid's knee. Bat ke pocha lagati hai. So guys, remember, if this is our patella, so pre-patellar bursitis is seen in housemaid's knee. Number second. Clergyman's knee, infra. If this is your patella, infrapatellar bursitis. Prepatellar is seen in housemaids team, and infrapatellar bursitis is seen in clergyman's team. Third thing is you guys. Yes, and you guys are actually MCQ of FMG. That this has been asked in the exam. Please remember, this has been asked in the exam. How you guys actually study? You put this elbow like this and you study. So because of this, this is known as early chronon bursitis. This was actually FMG exam question, and simple straight question was asked in student which bursitis is seen, and your answer was early chronon bursitis. Very, very simple. Early chronon bursitis. Next is Weaver's bottom. Guys, remember ischial bursitis. Taylor lateral bursitis. You all have to answer along with me. Housemaid's knee, which bursitis is seen? It is very, very important. That is why I'm asking you guys, and you all have to answer right now. Perfect. Chalo, jaldi se. Jaldi, I want your answer. This is prepatellar bursitis. Now, the second question to you guys, straight from Delhi to your heart. Clergyman's knee. If this is your patella and it is happening here, this is known as infrapatellar. That is known as infrapatellar. Student's elbow. FMG exam question. Student's elbow. Which bursitis is seen? That is your olecranon bursitis. What are the weaver's bottom? Weaver dhobi ke niche wale kya hota hai wahan pe, jaldi se bata do dosto. Ischial bursitis. Lateral bursitis. You all are correct, and my dear friends, you all are going to pass on 4th of June. Yes, 4th of June, you all are going to pass. Love you all. Let's talk about the Neet PG and FMG. Exam question. Guys, remember Neet PG and FMG exam question. Most common dislocations. Let me talk about the most common dislocation. Jaldi se batana. Number one, shoulder dislocation. If we talk about the shoulder dislocation, guys, remember, hum kandha kahan se maarte hain? Kisi ko koi maare ya chal raha hoga, to hum kaise kandha maarte hain? Aage se maarte hain. So most common shoulder dislocation is your anterior dislocation. Anterior dislocation. What about the elbow? हम किसी को पोनी कैसे मारते हैं? कोई पीछे खड़ा होता है, कैसे पोनी मारते हैं? ऐसे मार दो आगे जाके कि ऐसे करते हैं? How you do? This. So this is your posterior. This is your posterior dislocation. So most common shoulder dislocation is anterior dislocation. Most common posterior dislocation is seen in elbow. What about the hip? Guys? This was actually Neet PG exam question. So hip ke baare mein kya khayal hai dosto? Peaceful answer I need from you guys. Hip kahan se? Peeche se. Kya baat hai? हिप का नाम सुनते ही गुरु जी लाए हैं दमादार चॉकलेट, खाओ और खुशियां बरसाओ. क्या बात है. ठीक है, चलो गाइस, रिमेंबर सम स्टूडेंट्स आर वेरी वेलकम, दे आर सेइंग डॉगी स्टाइल. हिप डिसलोकेशन इज पोस्टीरियर. हिप डिसलोकेशन इज मोस्ट कॉमन इज पोस्टीरियर. एंड दिस वाज योर एग्जाम का क्वेश्चन. व्हाट अबाउट द नी? तुम नी कैसे मारते हो किसी को? आगे से. दिस इज योर एंटीरियर. सो हाउ नी इज डिसलोकेटेड? एंटीरियर. व्हाट अबाउट द पटेला? ला 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 लैटरली. पटेला लैटरली. ऑल ऑफ यू हैव टू आंसर. प्लीज जो आंसर देगा उसे मिलेगा शानदार मीठा ताजा चॉकलेट, गरम चॉकलेट. तो किसको चाहिए गरम चॉकलेट? प्लीज आंसर. शोल्डर डिसलोकेशन, मोस्ट कॉमन शोल्डर डिसलोकेशन. Most common shoulder dislocation, my dear friend. Most common shoulder dislocation. Jaldi se. Perfect. Elbow. What about the elbow? Yes, elbow. Please, elbow. Elbow ka kya scene hai bhai? Elbow. Yes, answer is posterior. Hip. Hip ka sunte hi mere doston ke man mein jo rang birange khayal aa rahe honge, I can feel you guys. बट दोस्तों, क्या हमें डिस्ट्रैक्ट होना है 4 तारीख? नहीं सर, इनको समझा दो, चाहे हिप हो जाए, चाहे आगे से हो, डॉर्सल हो, चाहे मेडुला हो, कोई भी पार्ट शुड नॉट डिस्ट्रैक्ट देम अंटिल दे आर पास अंटिल दे आर पास दिस टाइम इन चैंटिंग यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू शो एनी बॉडी पार्ट
वाज कंट्रोवर्सी व्हाट अबाउट द नी 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 व्हाट अबाउट द नी व्हाट अबाउट द नी माय डियर फ्रेंड व्हाट अबाउट द नी गाइस रिमेंबर नी इज आल्सो एंटीरियर एम्पटी ला 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 इज योर ला 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 इज योर लैटरल डन 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 Syndromes has been asked in the FMG exam, that is why I've taken this topic also. And within 3 minutes, we are going to learn all three syndromes and which nerve is involved. Actually, it is very, very simple. Cubital tunnel syndrome, UUU, cubital ulnar. Guyon's canal syndrome, it is ulnar nerve. Guyon canal syndrome, that is your ulnar nerve. Guyon canal syndrome, that is your ulnar nerve. Guys, remember, tunnel kahan pe hoti hai? कुछ टनल्स पहाड़ों में होती है कुछ टांगों के तो टनल कहाँ पे होती है जल्दी बताओ टनल कहाँ पे होती है साइड पे होती है कि बीच में होती है गाइस टनल इज ऑलवेज बीच कहीं भी बीच में कहीं भी पहाड़ों के बीच या कहीं भी बीच में हो सकती है सो गाइस रिमेंबर कार्पल टनल सिंड्रोम मीडियन नर्व इज इन्वॉल्व माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन टू यू क्यूबिटल टनल सिंड्रोम व्हिच नर्व इज इन्वॉल्व क्यूबिटल tunnel syndrome which nerve is involved cubital tunnel syndrome which nerve is involved my dear friend which nerve is involved in cubital tunnel that is your ulnar nerve that is your ulnar nerve that is your ulnar nerve ulnar nerve ulnar nerve ulnar nerve ulnar nerve perfect Guyon's canal syndrome what about the Guyon's canal syndrome what about the Guyon's canal syndrome yes my dear friend Guyon's canal syndrome ulnar nerve ulnar nerve ulnar nerve carpal tunnel what I have told you just now yes my dear carpal tunnel syndrome tunnel 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 which nerve is involved that is your median nerve that is your median nerve perfect let's talk about all the fractures and one marks is guaranteed in neet pg and fmg also from the fracture for the next 10 minutes you have to stay very much active for the fractures because this is very tricky topic and we are going to make this very very simple for you guys in the next 10 minutes are you all ready yes my dear friends love you all are you all ready yes the two type of fractures are there open or closed fracture open or closed fracture at the base of fracture line let's divide various fractures number one thing is transverse fracture see the line of the fracture is transverse going like this that is why this is your transverse fracture that is your transverse fracture oblique now fracture line is going oblique and it is starting from the one and going to the other and that is your complete fracture this is your oblique fracture if septum fragment is coming out from a bone this is known as your butterfly fragment kya kehta hai banke tusi butterfly kithe nu chalyo Comminuted fracture. If more than two segments are broken from end to end fracture lines are seen this is known as segmental fracture ab main hilaunga aur tum mujhe batao isko screen ko aur tum mujhe bataoge ki kaun sa fracture hai kya main hilaun matlab screen ko hilaun jaldi batao hila do jaldi se jaldi batao hilaun nahi hilaun screen hilaunga and you all have to answer chalo na 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 ये कौन सा फ्रैक्चर है जल्दी से बताओ कौन सा फ्रैक्चर है गाइस दिस ऐसे वाला कौन सा था जल्दी से बताओ दिस इज योर व्हिच फ्रैक्चर यस ऑल ऑफ माय फ्रेंड्स आर राइट वेरी वेरी राइट दैट इज योर ऑब्लिक फ्रैक्चर दोबारा हिलाऊं जल्दी बताओ दोबारा हिलाऊं कि नहीं हिलाऊं मुझे YouTube की चैट नहीं दिख रही मैं इनकी बात नहीं सुन पा रहा हूं सर हटाओ ये बिल्कुल धीरे चल रहा है जल्दी से दोबारा हिलाऊं कि नहीं हिलाऊं ठीक है जल्दी से भाई जल्दी लेट मी ओपन माय लाइव चैट एंड आई वांट टू सी यू गाइस आंसरिंग वेरी वेरी नाइसली थिंकिंग ऑफ वेरी वेरी नाइस थिंग गाइस रिमेंबर दिस इज जल्दी ये कौन सा फ्रैक्चर है जल्दी से दिस इज व्हिच फ्रैक्चर प्लीज दिस इज व्हिच फ्रैक्चर गाइस माय डियर फ्रेंड्स व्हिच फ्रैक्चर इज दिस This is your which fracture? Spiral fracture, guys, please answer very seriously, please tell me which fracture is this, which fracture is this. Oh, nice, so good, they all are going to pass, sir, mark my word, they all are going to pass, and you all are going to get these chocolates. Last time the people who went on Noida Center, we have full bag of chocolates for them. Best wishes, and this time Trut Burger. Love you all, Trut Burger. Perfect. So, let's talk about the complication. Very, very important and high yield topic. Complication, early and the delayed complication. Let's talk about the early complication. Number one thing is happening is shock. Either it is hypovolemic shock, either it is neurologic shock. Because of excess pain, also patient can go into shock, and because of excess blood loss, also patient can go into shock. So number one complication early vola is shock. Fat embolism. Yes, my dear friend, in the femoral, this is actually Neet PG and Fmge exam question. Fat embolism is most commonly seen with a fracture of which bone? Which bone? That is your femur. That is your femur in road traffic accident. In the femoral bone fracture, this is most commonly seen fat embolism. How this is fatal? This fat embolism from the femoral side, it can go from the femoral vein and it can enter into the heart. And from heart, it can go into your lungs. There it can create massive destruction and patient can die. That is why fat embolism, it is very, very, very vulnerable. Okay? Next is your MCQ, PYQ, compartment syndrome. Can you tell me which flexion is this? If my hand is down like this, can you tell me which flexion is this? Which flexion is this? Which flexion is this? It is plantar or dorsi? 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 Please tell me. It is plantar or dorsi? Jaldi se. It is your plantar, right? Remember, plantar flexion ke andar plants, the roots are down. Remember, this is plantar flexion. Dur jate hain, jab hum dur jate hain, to flight mein baith ke jate hain, to is tarike se hamara haath jata hai upar ki taraf. So if my hand is like this, this is known as dorsiflexion. If my hand is like this, this is known as plantar flexion. This is known as plantar flexion. And what is happening in the compartment syndrome? Guys, there is a negative pressure created between the skin and your muscle. In the fascia, actually, the negative pressure is created, which is very, very, very painful, and this is actually a surgical emergency. Patient would be coming to you and would be complaining, Dr. Saab would be coming to you like hand like this. Painful dorsiflexion. Swan neck hand is seen in this. Painful dorsiflexion is seen. What treatment? And what, because of this negative pressure, you will see Waksman ischemia, MCQ. Waksman ischemia is seen in which patient? My question to you, Waksman ischemia is seen in which? Waksman ischemia is seen in which disease? Guys, remember, your answer is compartment syndrome. What is the treatment? As I already told you, this is a surgical emergency. What is the treatment you can give to this patient? Guys, remember, urgent fasciotomy. Urgent fasciotomy is a perfect treatment. Urgently, you have to give to release the negative pressure over there. Perfect. This is a surgery integrated topic. Let's talk about the delayed complication. Very, very important. Number one is myositis ossificans. A word myositis ossificans is already telling you what myositis means, muscle. Ossificans when it is converted into bone. The extra calcification in the muscle is actually looking, it actually make a muscle look like a bone. This is known as myositis ossificans. And most commonly, ossification of fractured hematoma. Whenever there is a hematoma formation, there's much more chances of that hematoma to be converted into myositis ossificans, that is your bone, the muscle converted into bone. Muscle converted into bone. Can you tell me most common muscle involved in this? Most common muscle involved in this. Most common muscle involved in myositis ossificans. My question to you, most common muscle involved in myositis ossificans, that is your brachialis. That is your brachialis. That is your brachialis. Perfect. And also, delayed complication is avascular necrosis. whenever the blood supply is not reaching any bone, that bone will go under necrosis. This is known as avascular necrosis. And this is actually your anatomy question, which is most common bone which is going under avascular necrosis, that is none other than scaphoid. And if you have studied anatomy, you all know this is boat shaped bone. Boat shaped bone. This is your boat shaped bone. Other thing is malunion and non-union. Malunion and non-union. Malunion matlab bone is attached, but that attachment is not at all normal anatomical attachment. That is abnormal and attachment. That is why it is known as malunion. What is non-union? If your bone is not at all joined with each other, that is known as non-union. If this is attached but not an anatomical normal attachment, that is known as malunion. Let's see in this picture. Now these two bones are attached with each other but not as proper anatomical functional attachment. What you will call this? Yes, my dear friends, you will call this as a malunion. Other picture, you can see the bones are not attached with each other. What you will call this, my dear friend? This is your non-union. This is your non-union. Non-union. Done, hai? This is all about the complication. Complication. Early complication and the late complication. Along with me, you have to devise for the next 30 seconds. Early complication, number one complication is shock, number two is fat embolism, and number third is your compartment syndrome. Compartment syndrome. If I talk about the delayed complication, number one complication we have studied is myositis ossificans. Number second is your avascular necrosis, and most common bone involved in the avascular necrosis is your scaphoid bone. Other third one is malunion, and the fourth one is a non-union. The fourth one is your non-union. Let's talk about all the fracture. I've already taken you 10 minutes. Now 2 minutes are over. 8 minutes for next 8 minutes. Yes, my dear friends, for the next 8 minutes, stay active. Are you all awake? Kya hum aaj khana late kha sakte hain? क्या हम आज खाना लेट खा सकते हैं जस्ट टू पास दिस एग्जाम? कैन वी स्किप मील फॉर अनदर वन आवर जस्ट टू पास दिस एग्जाम? क्या हम ये बलिदान देने को तैयार है? यस, वी कैन सैक्रिफाइस जस्ट बिकॉज वी लव टू अचीव आवर ड्रीम ऑन टाइम. यस, चलो, ऑल आर विद मी, ऑल आर विद मी. नंबर वन इज क्लेविकल. नंबर वन इज योर क्लेविकल. नंबर वन इज योर clavicle. Guys, remember clavicle fracture. Most common bone to get fracture overall in the body. Yes, my dear friend, even during the delivery, the most common bone which is going to fracture in the life also, if most common bone which is going to fracture is your clavicle. And anatomy question has been asked from this, guys. Remember, most common side is very, very important. That is medial two-third, lateral one-third. So please, all of you have to write in the chat box, most common overall bone in the body to get fractured. Overall in the body to get fractured is your clavicle. And if I ask you, what is the most common site of fracture of clavicle? What is your answer? Medially two-third, laterally one-third. That is the exact MCQ has been asked in the FMG exam. And in treatment, which splint you will give? The person who will answer will get this lovely chocolate. Can I ask you? Yes, your correct answer is figure of eight. Yeah. Splint is used to treat the clavicle fracture. Yes, my dear. Next, number second fracture is fracture of neck of humerus, PYQ. Yes, this is your repeat question. Nerve injured is axillary nerve. Along with me, please speak. Never ever confuse with these things, guys. These are very simple things, and these silly mistakes actually we don't have to do because we are doing chanting. Chanting mein yehi to sikhaya jata hai. What is smart studies? How you study 20 hours subject in 2 hours? How to get 4 to 5 marks in 2 hours? This is all about the chanting. Yehi to kamaal hai, magic hai, isi ka to kamaal hai. Dosto, mere saath. Neck of humerus means nerve injured, sir. The nerve injured is axillary nerve. The nerve injured is axillary nerve. Sir, the shaft of humerus pin. जब कोई नया नया रिलेशनशिप में आता है तो वो अपनी गर्लफ्रेंड को क्या बोलता है, उसकी गर्लफ्रेंड क्या बोलती, बेबी आज मुझे तुम्हारी बाहों में सुना। तो वो बेचारा नौजवान अपनी बेबी को जब बाहों में सुलाता है, बाहें खा गई ये रे, तो बाहों में सुलाता है तो उन देवी जी का सर इस जगह पे आता है, यहाँ पे आता है, शाफ्ट ऑफ ह्यूमरस।
इतने बड़े सर वाले आए क्यों,
तो तुम ऐसे सुला देते हो उसको पूरी रात, ऐसे ऐसे सो जाते हो, है ना बेबी बाबू, सोना दोना दोना करते करते सो जाते हो। जब सुबह उठते हो दोस्तों तो तुम देखते हो ऐसे हो गए तुम, है ना, रात भर ऐसे सोए थे, फिर होना चाहिए था ऐसे बिल्कुल, है ना, और हो गया ऐसे। दिस मीन रिस्ट ड्रॉप, रिस्ट ड्रॉप इज सीन विद द इंजरी ऑफ रेडियल नर्व, द शाफ्ट ऑफ ह्यूमरस में व्हिच नर्व इज गॉन, व्हिच नर्व इज गॉन ऑन द शाफ्ट ऑफ ह्यूमरस। तो अपनी जो नई नई बेबियां बनती हैं उनको शाफ्ट मत सुलाना, मत सुलाना, वरना तुम्हें क्या हो सकता है सर, रेडियल। कभी आपके हुआ सर?
नहीं, मैं ऐसे
और उसको बोलोगे उस पे सो प्लीज, ये मेरी शाफ्ट पे इंजरी हो सकती है, और सर ने मुझे सिखाया था शाफ्ट इंजरी में रेडियल नर्व की इंजरी होती है, और रेडियल नर्व की इंजरी से फिर ऐसे हो जाता है, रिस्ट ड्रॉप हो जाती है। परफेक्ट 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 परफेक्ट, ठीक है जी। तो बेबी बाबू छोना दोना, ठीक है, अलग से सोना, colis fracture guys has been asked in the exam, and very simple trick to answer this guys, remember fracture of distal end of radius within 1 inch above the radius styloid process. Number one thing you have to remember, what colis fracture is, a fracture of which bone? Number one question is, colis fracture is a fracture of which bone? My dear friend, your first answer is radius bone. Which part of radius bone? Your answer is distal part of radius bone. Third thing is, where in the distal part you will see, say 1 inch above the radial styloid process. Now, along with this, guys, remember, fracture of distal end of radius within 1 inch above the radial styloid process. And patient would be coming to you, guys, remember. Whenever the patient would be coming to you, patient would be saying to you that, Dr. Saab, I was having a history of fall onto outstretched hand, that is known as push. जब भी तुम्हारे पास patient आया और तुम्हें बुलाया कि डॉक्टर साहब मैं सीधे हाथों पे गिरा था और मेरे हाथ में fracture हो गया, the first thing always remember should come in your mind. What is that first thing? Please answer. That is your colis fracture. That is the colis fracture. Now you ask your patient, please get me your x-ray, and on x-ray which deformity you are going to see is your 100% MCQ. Which deformity you are going to see in the x-ray, my dear friends? Can you tell me the name of deformity? Yes, that is none other than dinner fork deformity. So dinner fork deformity is seen in which fracture? Guys, dinner fork deformity is seen in which fracture? This is seen in your colis fracture. Dinner fork deformity is seen in your colis fracture. Colis fracture. And patient would be coming to you with the history of which mode of injury? Push. Kya yaad hai colis mein? Push. Next fracture is number fifth fracture. That is your Smith fracture. Yes, my dear friend. Smith is totally opposite to the colis, and one thing you have to remember, this is also a fracture of distal end of radius. Now the another thing you have to remember here is the displacement. In colis fracture there was no displacement, but in the Smith fracture there is a displacement, and they both are fracture of distal end of radius. So colis fracture and Smith fracture are the fracture of distal end of radius with the displacement of lower fragment, which is opposite to the colis. And which and patient would be coming to you with which mode of injury? Flex the hand, falling onto flex the hand like this. Agar is tarike se gira hoga to Polish Smith fracture. Agar falling onto outstretched hand pe gira hoga, that is known as your Coulee's fracture. And when you ask this patient to get a x-ray, which deformity you will see on the x-ray in the Smith fracture? That is your Gardner's deformity. Done it? So dinner fork deformity seen in Coulee's, Gardner's deformity seen in Smith fracture, and they both are fracture of radius bone, distal end of radius. Displacement is seen in Smith and 1 inch above the radial styloid process of the distal radius, that is your Coulee's fracture. Dun 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 dun. Are we all clear? Crystal clear? Coulee's and Smith may question aega. Will you confuse or you will be able to solve? Can I trust you guys? Yes, I can trust you guys. Next fracture is your Batten's fracture. Guys, remember, Batten's fracture is a fracture of distal end of radius involving the articular surface. Articular surface is a joint space. Is the joint space present over here? Let me show you how this fracture is occurring. This is a fracture of, again, this is the third fracture we are learning of the distal radius. Now you can see appreciated joint space over there. The fracture line is actually touching this joint space, that is, it is involving the articular surface. This is your Batten's fracture. On x-ray, it will look like this. This fracture line, which is actually coming to your articular surface, this is your Batten's fracture. Batten's fracture is also a fracture of distal end of radius. What is a special feature in the Batten's fracture? That is your involvement of articular surface. Next is scaphoid fracture. A most common fracture bone in the hand. Guys, remember, in the hand, which bone is most commonly getting fractured? Your answer is scaphoid, and is the most common carpal bone to get fractured, was your exam the question. Second thing, most common to go under avascular necrosis. Most common bone to go under avascular necrosis is none other than your scaphoid bone. Can you all tell me the shape of scaphoid bone? That is none other than your boat shape. Scaphoid. Then, how NCI can confuse you, how NB can confuse you? They can ask you overall, in most common in the body, bone to get fractured. My question to you, overall most common bone to get fractured in the body. My first question to you, overall which bone is most commonly fractured in the body, full body we're talking about? Medially, two-third, laterally, one-third. Which bone was the figure of eight splint was given? Which was that? Clavicle bone is a perfect answer. Love you all, and you all are going to pass. Ye raaton ki mehnat, ye cheekna chillana tumhare kaam aayega. And exam center, when you are sitting, pichle itihas mein pooch lena, hamare jo pyare pyare doctors wahan pe gaye the, wo bata rahe the ki screen dekh ke sir ab aapki awaazein kaan mein goonjti thi aur batati thi ki sir ye answer hai. यही एटीट्यूड लेके एग्जाम में जाना है. हम गलत नहीं कर सकते क्योंकि हमने वो हर मुमकिन कोशिश करी है जो पास होने के लिए रिक्वायर्ड होती है. हमने हर रात हर दिन पढ़ाई करी है. अब हमें पास होने से कोई नहीं रोक सकता. हे भगवान, अब तुझे मुझे पास करना पड़ेगा क्योंकि मैंने इतनी मेहनत करी है. बिल्कुल शाबाश. नेक्स्ट इज Rolando fracture is a fracture of thumb. Yes, Rolando fracture is a fracture of thumb. So, कैसे याद करना है Rolando? Rolando कैसे याद करना Ronaldo? Ronaldo क्या है सर? बहुत ही जबरदस्त लड़ाई खिलाड़ी है. उसने किक मारी और जो गोलकीपर खड़ा था, जैसे उसने उसको गोल को रोकने की कोशिश करी, उसके थंब का फ्रैक्चर हुआ. तो Rolando फ्रैक्चर में क्या आपने बताया?
हाथ लगाया,
थंब. इट इज अ फ्रैक्चर ऑफ थंब. रोलांडो फ्रैक्चर इज अ फ्रैक्चर ऑफ
thumb. You can easily see in this x-ray, you can see easily the thumb is broken. That is your Rolando. Rolando. Messi ke kitne fan hai aur Rolando ke kitne fan hai? Jaldi bata do chat box mein. Messi wale aur Rolando wale. Boxer's fracture. Let's talk about the boxer's fracture. How you do boxing? With the one hand or with the one hand pura use karte ho na. Main kuch aur cheez bolne wala tha na. So guys, remember, with the one hand you are doing boxing and you are all using your five fingers. You all are using your five fingers. So remember, boxer's fracture is a fracture of fifth metacarpal. To mukha kaise maarte ho? Panch ungliyon se. Panch ungliyon se maarte ho, hai na? So boxer's fracture is a fracture of fifth metacarpal bone. It is easily visible in this x-ray. This is a fracture of fifth metacarpal bone. That is your which fracture? That is your boxer's fracture. That is your boxer's fracture. Boxer's fracture. Dun, 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 dun. Let's talk about the mallet finger. Yes, let's talk about the mallet finger. Evolution of the extensor ligament. Ligament is a structure which is actually connecting a bone with a bone. Mallet finger, there is a no fracture of a bone. There is a fracture of ligament. And if I specifically ask you which ligament, your answer is extensor ligament. Your answer is extensor ligament. That is from the distal phalanx. So mallet finger is a evolution of extensor ligament. Extensor ligament. Very, very, very simple. Very, very, very simple. Supracondylar fracture. 100% MCQ on 4th of June and repeated question of Neet PG and FMG. Neet PG and FMG and the middle of night. 722 are live, my dear friend. This is a record. Isse pata chalta hai, now they are serious for the exam and they all deserve this chocolate. Oh, all deserve this chocolate. My dear friend, next is your supracondylar fracture of the humerus. Guys, which deformity? Ye kaisi dikh rahi hai? बंदूक मेरी रानी कैसी दिख रही है? जल्दी से बताओ. बंदूक जल्दी से प्लीज जल्दी से. दिस इज योर गन स्टॉक डिफॉर्मिटी. दिस इज योर ये क्या आ गया भाई? ये चैट में क्या आ गया? ये गन स्टॉक डिफॉर्मिटी. ये
बताओ मैसे
दुष्ट पापी. ये दुष्ट पापी बोल रहा है. Which deformity is seen? That is your gun stock deformity. Guys, a repeated MCQ Montesi or Galesi pe question har baar aata hai. For the next 1 minute, please listen to me very, very, very carefully. And we are very simply going to learn the difference between Montesi and Galesi. Every time we are confused between Montesi and Galesi. Guys, remember, first of all, Montesia is a fracture of proximal 1/3 of ulna. Yes, Galesi is a fracture of distal end of radius. Distal end of radius. Guys, remember, those who are distracted for the other subject, let me tell you something. Please, jo hai pehle wo to padh. Kya pata kal ko wo bhi ho jaye. Ye kara rahe hain, wo kara do. Wo karayenge, kuch aur kara do. End mein result kya hoga phir? Please stay focused. अभी कुछ कराया जा रहा है, उस पे ध्यान दो, उसको सुनो, समझो, याद करो, तुम्हारे काम आएगा. Please don't get distracted easily.
Yes.
You all are going to become doctor on 4th of June. Please stay focused with folded hands. I'm requesting you. ठीक है? चल. Montesia. ठीक है? ऐसा ना हो कल को कॉपीराइट की वजह से हमें वीडियो हटानी पड़ जाए. इसीलिए अभी जो ज्ञान मिल रहा है उसको बटोर लो. प्लीज स्टे एक्टिव. So Montesia is a fracture of ulna. Galesi is a fracture of radius. Where actually it is happening? So Montesia. First of all, we'll talk about the Montesia. दोबारा से आगे सही बंदा.
अरे यार, भाई फ्लाइंग कर रहा हूँ.
जो शरीर के पास है वो प्रॉक्सिमल है, जो शरीर के दूर है वो डिसगेयर है. सो मोंटेजिया इज द फ्रैक्चर ऑफ विच बोन? इट इज द फ्रैक्चर ऑफ प्रॉक्सिमल वन थर्ड ऑफ अल्ना along with radial head dislocation, on the other hand Galesi, is a fracture of distal and of radius with the displacement of, yes, with the dislocation of or the displacement of radio ulnar joint, chalo pehchante hain. This is a fracture of proximal one third of ulna. Which fracture is this? This is your Montegia. What is dislocated over here? Whose head? Which bone is dislocated? Which bone's head is dislocated over here? That is none other your radial head. So Montegia fracture mein proximal one third. Montegia fracture mein, it is a fracture of proximal one third of ulna with the displacement of radial head, perfect. Galesi is a fracture of distal radial bone. Along with the dislocation of radio ulnar joint. Radio ulnar joint is present over there. There is a dislocation in the Galesi. There is a dislocation of radio ulnar joint, and Galesi is a fracture of distal end of radius. One MCQ was asked in the anatomy, which joint is responsible for supination and pronation? Your answer is radio ulnar joint. Supination is this thing, pronation is this thing. Ulta karoge pronation, seedha karoge supination. This is your supination and pronation that is actually happening on the radio ulnar joint. Let's talk about the shoulder joint dislocation. Guys, remember, shoulder joint, this is your humerus. Humerus is actually fitting into the glenoid cavity. This is a glenoid cavity, and your humerus bone head is actually going into this. Whenever there is a dislocation, can you tell me which is the most common dislocation of the shoulder? Can you all tell me? That is your anterior dislocation. Guys, remember, when there is a dislocation, there is a friction. This will go like this. One, the bone will be fractured. Other, this glenoid cavity would be fractured, or it will be torn down. So, two things will break. One, the bone will break. Glenoid cavity, glenoid lacerum, will also be avulsion. So, two things we will see. Number one, PYQ MCQ, which has asked in the Neet PG also and Fmge also, that is Hill Sachs lesion. Hill Sachs lesion is seen on the bone, and Bankart lesion is seen on the glenoid labrum. So guys, remember this too. The Hill Sachs is seen on the bone head of humerus, and other hand, glenoid labrum is seen. Glenoid labrum pe kya dekhne milta hai? Bankart lesion. So two lesions are very much important, has been asked in the exam. Number one thing is your Hill Sachs lesion, which is present impression fracture on the posterior part of humerus head. So where this Hill Sachs lesion is actually occurring, guys, remember, this is very important. Impression fracture on the posterior part of humerus head. Perfect. Glenoid labrum is damaged. Whenever glenoid labrum is damaged, which lesion is seen? Your answer is Bankart lesion. Next is developmental dysplasia of the hip. Developmental dysplasia of the hip. Guys, remember, this is a normal x-ray. This is a normal x-ray. This, the head of femur is now into acetabulum. In the pelvic bone, there is an acetabulum cavity where your femur ka head is actually fixing. This is a normal x-ray. But in the developmental dysplasia of the hip, you can actually appreciate the head of femur is going somewhere else. Is going somewhere else. This is DDH, developmental dysplasia of the hip. Developmental dysplasia. Whenever this kind of x-ray would be coming into their exam, the first diagnosis you have to make is this. That is, your head of femur is not at all present in the acetabulum cavity, is going somewhere else. This is developmental dysplasia of the hip. Yes. And guys, remember which splint is used. We are going to talk in just 10 minutes. In the next 10 minutes, we are all are going to learn splint, because from fracture 1 mark, from splint 100% 1 mark is going to come. Next is Salter Harris classification. Very important topic for Neet PG. Salter Harris classification. Let's talk about the growth plate. This is a growth plate, guys. Remember, number one is mnemonic. What is the mnemonic? Salter. Mnemonic for Salter Harris classification is Salter. And guys, remember, number one is separate growth plate. Number one thing is separate growth plate. Uske baad sir kya hota hai? Pehle to juda hote hain. To kya bolte hain? Char dinon da आप कुछ बच्चों ने जगह की जगह च सुना होगा.
Yes.
दिमाग में ऐसा कुछ नहीं आना चाहिए. तो एक बार दोबारा गाऊंगा, मेरे साथ साथ गाएंगे सब लोग जोर जोर से अपने घरों में.
आओ मेरे
चार दिन दा प्यार रब्बा बड़ी लंबी. बस मुझे बोलने की जरूरत भी नहीं पड़ी, इन्होंने मन में ही गा दिया. इन्होंने मन में ही वो गा दिया.
Very good.
So guys, remember, above the growth plate. Number one is separate growth plate. उसके बाद ऊपर से शुरुआत करनी है above the growth plate. तो माहौल कहाँ से बनना शुरू होता है? सर नीचे से कि ऊपर से?
ऊपर
से. So number second step in the Salter Harris classification is your above the growth plate. Above the growth plate. फिर ऊपर से कहाँ जाया जाता है सर?
ऊपर से फिर हम जाएंगे थोड़ा नीचे.
नीचे जाएंगे ना? तो number third is your below the growth plate. सबसे पहले जुदा हुए. जुदा होने के बाद मिले तो मुलाकात हुई. ऊपर से शुरू करी
नजरों से,
फिर नीचे नजरों से, फिर नीचे की तरफ. ये नीचे दिल होता है, नीचे दिल होता है. फिर क्या, उसे ऊपर नीचे हो गया, फोर प्ले हो गया. उसके बाद ऊपर नीचे
अंदर
नीचे ऊपर नीचे भी हो सकता था. ऊपर नीचे ऊपर नीचे. तो कैसे रिमेंबर? थ्रू द ग्रोथ प्लेट. थ्रू द ग्रोथ प्लेट. और उसके बाद दूरियां मिट गई, एक हो गए हम दो. फिर उन्होंने क्या बोला? हम दो एक कमरे में बंद हो जाए और चाबी खो जाए और चाबी खो जाए. तो गाइस रिमेंबर सॉल्टर हैरिस क्लासिफिकेशन इससे बैटर निमोनिक मार्केट में नहीं. ठीक है, सबसे पहले जुदा थे. क्या बोला? चार दिन आधा प्यार रब्बा बड़ी लंबी जुदाई लंबी जुदाई. एक बार प्यार शुरू हुआ तो ऊपर से अबव द ग्रोथ प्लेट, फिर नीचे से बिलो द ग्रोथ प्लेट, फिर ऊपर नीचे थ्रू द ग्रोथ प्लेट. और फिर क्या हुआ? मिट गई दूरियां. इरेजर ऑफ ग्रोथ प्लेट. इरेजर ऑफ ग्रोथ प्लेट. तो अलोंग विद मी साल्टर हैरिस क्लासिफिकेशन मन में बोलो. सबसे पहले इमेजिन करो, सबसे पहले बहुत दिन हो गए मिले मिले, तो क्या करोगे? मिलने की बात हुई, चलो जी आ जाओ दिल्ली में, आ जाओ मिल लो. भाई कहां पे मिलोगे? दिल्ली में कहां मिलोगे? कुतुब मीनार, चार मीनार. कहां पे? दिल्ली में चार मीनार है भी है कि नहीं? नहीं है भाई, गलत बोल दिया. ठीक है, चल गाइस, सबसे पहले ऊपर से, फिर नीचे से, फिर ऊपर नीचे से, है ना? ऊपर नीचे से हुआ, उसके बाद दूरियां मिट गई, है ना? चलो बहुत बढ़िया, बहुत बढ़िया, है ना? साल्टर हैरिस क्लासिफिकेशन. आई होप यू ऑल हैव लर्न अबाउट द Salter Harris classification. Let's talk about all the deformities. Yes, let's talk about all the deformities. Guys, remember, elbow is known as cubitus. Elbow is known as cubitus. Hip is known as coxa, and the knee is known as gent. Chal, ye term yaad karte hain. Elbow is known as. Elbow is known as. Jaldi se. Elbow is known as. Elbow is known as. Elbow is known as. Elbow is known as. Elbow is known as cubitus, hip is known as coxa, knee is known as genu, knee is known as genu, knee is known as genu, knee is known as Genu. So, let me take talk about a very simple mnemonic, guys. If there is a space between two organs, there is a rasta. There is a rasta that is known as varus. If the two structures are attached with each other, that is known as valgus. That is known as valgus. Let me talk to you to the example of my legs. If in between my legs there is a path, that is known as valgus. Rasta hai rasta. Agar dono tange judi hui ho, this is known as valgus. Valgus. Let's learn about the different organs. Like we have already taught you, elbow is known as cubitus. So, jaldi se batao, if there is rasta. Jaldi se batao, if there is rasta between my, between my elbow. This is known as. Pehle to elbow ko kya bolte the? Cubitus. Varus. If my elbow is like this, it is attached like this. This is known as cubitus valgus. Perfect. Let's talk about a hip. Hip. The coxa is the normal angle present in the hip, the bone, and chum. Guys, remember the normal angle is between 120 to 135. 122, 135. This is known as coxa. If the angle is less than 120, that is known as coxa vara. If angle is more than 135, that is known as coxa valga. So my question to you, guys, remember, coxa vara is the angle less than. Coxa vara is the angle less than
120 degree.
Coxa valga is the angle more than 135, and this coxa normal angle value has been asked in the Fmge exam. Next is your genu. Tango ke beech mein maine kya bola tha, knees ko we call as genu. If there is a way, agar rasta present hai, what we call this? Very, very good. That is known as varus. Genu varum. If there is no rasta between the legs are attached. Gum ki saath attached hai saath mein, this is known as genu valgum. All are clear.
Yes.
Crystal clear, genu valgum, valgus, sab cheeze clear hai. Swan neck deformity and botnia's deformity, very, very, very important, guys. Swan neck deformity and botnia's deformity has been asked in the exam, so this is very, very, very important. How is the josh? To bolenge, kya bolenge? I will pass. Yes. Swan neck deformity, just one thing you have to remember, and other thing would be very, very, very simple. The first thing you have to remember, ek hota hai PIP, ek hota hai DIP, proximal intraphalangeal joint, theek hai, and distal intraphalangeal joint, PIP and PIP. Proximal means close to the body, I'm talking about this PIP. DIP, I'm talking about the distal part, interphalangeal joint, which is present distally. So in the swan neck deformity, you just have to remember one thing. And what one thing you have to remember, that is, what is the position of PIP? Guys, remember the position of PIP is hyperextension. Rest, everything would be very, very, very simple. So PIP is in hyperextension in swan neck deformity. What will happen to the DIP? DIP would be opposite to the hyperflexion. That is your hyperextension. That is your flexion. Now, Botnia's deformity is just opposite to the swan neck deformity. So in the swan neck deformity, PIP pe ho rahi thi kya hyperextension. तो मैंने बोला बॉटनियस डिफॉर्मिटी इज ऑपोजिट टू द स्वान नेक डिफॉर्मिटी. सो पीआईपी पे कैन यू टेल मी पीआईपी में व्हाट विल हैपन इन द बॉटनियस डिफॉर्मिटी इफ इट इज ऑपोजिट टू द स्वान नेक डिफॉर्मिटी व्हाट विल हैपन. पीआईपी विल बी हाइपर एक्सटेंशन एंड डीआईपी वुड बी ऑपोजिट दैट इज योर हाइपर फ्लेक्शन दैट इज योर फ्लेक्शन दैट इज योर फ्लेक्शन. तो जल्दी से बता दो मेरे को, लेट मी आस्क यू एमसीक्यू. स्वान नेक डिफॉर्मिटी पीआईपी पे क्या होगा, जस्ट टेल मी पीआईपी, रेस्ट एवरीथिंग वुड बी सिंपल. पीआईपी पे व्हाट इज हैपनिंग, पीआईपी पे व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन द स्वान नेक डिफॉर्मिटी, कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन द पीआईपी स्वान नेक डिफॉर्मिटी. जल्दी से बताओ स्वान नेक डिफॉर्मिटी क्या हो रहा है, स्वान नेक डिफॉर्मिटी जल्दी से. एक्चुअली दैट इज नॉट अ फ्रैक्चर ना, दैट इज अ ब्यूटी. ठीक है चलो, हाइपर एक्सटेंशन. तो डीआईपी पे क्या होगा, डीआईपी पे क्या होगा स्वान नेक डिफॉर्मिटी, जल्दी से बता दो. डीआईपी में हाइपर हाइपर एक्सटेंशन का उल्टा क्या है, फ्लेक्शन. क्या है, फ्लेक्शन. तो बॉटनियस डिफॉर्मिटी में क्या होगा, पीआईपी पे, पीआईपी पे बॉटनियस में क्या होगा, फ्लेक्शन. एंड डीआईपी में क्या होगा, हाइपर एक्सटेंशन. डन डना डन डना डन, वेरी सिंपल. जस्ट वन थिंग यू हैव टू रिमेंबर इन पीआईपी, sorry, in swan neck deformity, PIP pe what is happening? Just this thing you have to remember, PIP pe hyperextension is happening. Hyperextension is happening. Hyperextension is happening. Just, are we all clear the difference between the swan neck and the botnius deformity? Yes, my dear friend. Next is the wind sweep deformity. Yes, wind sweep deformity, it is seen in rheumatoid arthritis. This was actually MCI exam question. The image was this one. And इतना बड़ा केस है. क्या आप इतने बड़े केस से डरोगे? नहीं मेरे दोस्तों, बिल्कुल नहीं डर मैं. Wind sweep deformity seen in rheumatoid arthritis. See, ऐसा लग रहा है हवा का झोंका आया. तो क्या बोला? लाल दुपट्टा उड़ गया रे मेरा हवा के झोंके से, मुझको प्यार ने देख लिया हाय रे धोखे से. So guys, remember, wind sweep deformity is seen in rheumatoid arthritis. It is seen in rheumatoid arthritis. Next, neat PG exam question. Pencil cup deformity. Let me show you how. Can you see the cup here and it is like pencil is present in the cup. Can you appreciate on this areas? Yes, the pencil in cup deformity is seen in psoriatic arthritis. This was your neat exam question. So pencil cup deformity is seen in psoriatic arthritis. Psoriatic arthritis. Sir, can you see their Josh? How many people still are still here? Approximately 650 people are still. 650 people are still here. Guys, remember, yahi Josh tumhe end tak leke jayega. Tadi paar jana hai, to roz class lagana. बार जाना है तो रोज क्लास लगाना है, रोज बोलना है आई विल पास आई विल पास आई विल पास आई विल पास. ठीक है,
इज द वॉइस क्लियर नाउ?
वॉइस क्लियर, यस.
वॉइस क्लियर, सेटिंग्स,
यस, सेटिंग्स.
So I will
one thing I can guarantee for these guys, they are very much focused.
Yes.
Out of 23,000, these are people who are actually focused, they are actually serious for the exam, they are even sacrificing their meal, today's meal. And along with you guys, we also haven't eaten anything. He was taking full day class. I was in hospital full day. Okay, so we all are sacrificing because of your dreams. Our vision, your dream will make this happen together. Are you all with me? For the next 30 minutes, are you all with me? आज सारी सारे अर्थों याद करके आज 19 मिनट से एक सेकंड कम करना है सर. आज करके सोना है वरना नींद कैसे आ जाए मुझे.
18 बचे,
मुझे नींद कैसे आ सकती है? मैं आज खत्म करके सोऊंगा तो आज ही खत्म करके सोऊंगा, ये मेरा वादा है, वादा है, वादा है.
यस,
बिल्कुल, यस. चल 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 चल, लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द स्प्रिंट. 100% गारंटीड एमसीक्यू बिफोर स्टार्टिंग स्प्रिंट. लेट्स रिवाइज ऑल द फ्रैक्चर्स, लेट्स रिवाइज ऑल द फ्रैक्चर्स, डिफॉर्मिटी एंड द फ्रैक्चर्स, क्विकली क्विकली. दिस इज व्हिच डिफॉर्मिटी, दिस इज व्हिच डिफॉर्मिटी, जल्दी से आंसर दे दो. जल्दी से बता दो, विच डिफॉर्मिटी इज दिस? Just this wind sweep deformity. It is seen in wind sweep deformity is seen in. Is it seen in?
Yes.
Rheumatoid. This is known as. पहली बात तो knees को बोलते हैं क्या जीनू 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 balance है कि welcome This is what. This is what. This is what. They all are answering. They all are answering. Okay, this is what. Genu, genu, balga. Yes. Ah, salter head is classification. This is something maybe. Coming to one thing is durian. Number one thing is durian, separate growth plate. Number second thing is above that growth plate. Number third is below the growth plate. Number fourth is through the growth plate. And number fifth is irrigation of growth plate. Perfect. This is actually head of femur is actually out of acetabulum cavity. This is your DD at the developmental dysplasia of the hip, which splint is given bone rose splint is given. We are all going to love. Let's talk about these Montegia and Delazy. Montegia is a fracture of proximal one-third of ulna plus radial head dislocation. Delazy is a fracture of distal and of radius with the dislocation of radio-ulnar joint. Radio-ulnar joint. Perfect. This is a gunstock deformity. This is a gunstock deformity which is seen in supracondylar fracture of the humerus. Mallet finger, man, there is an avulsion. There is an avulsion. There is an avulsion of the extensor ligament from the distal phalanx. Distal. देखो proximal में कोई फर्क नहीं है, but the distal phalanx is flexed. Distal phalanx is flexed. ठीक है. This is a fracture of fifth metacarpal bone. Metacarpal bone. This is seen in boxer's fracture. If your thumb is fractured, this is known as Rolando fracture. This is known as Rolando. Your articular surface is involved in the distal end of radial fracture. That is none other than Barton's fracture. If your hand is being flexed like this and your patient is giving history and on x-ray, if Gardner's deformity is seen, Gardner shape deformity is seen, your answer is Smith fracture. If dinner fork deformity is seen on x-ray, that is the x-ray, that is a fracture of distal and of radius within 1 inch above the radial styloid process, that is known as your Cooley's fracture. Cooley's fracture. So which nerve is injured? जब baby को सुलाते हो कौन सी nerve जाती थी सर आपको याद है ना कौन सी nerve थी वो radial nerve. कौन सी radial nerve. तो क्या आप baby को सुलाओगे यहाँ पे कि बाबा होगे
नाथ को
radial सपने में मिलती है और कुड़ी मुझे सपने में मिलती है Ready, 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 ready
this is used in the fracture of femur bone. Femur bone. This is which splint? Thoma splint. This is thoma splint. Thoma splint. Thoma splint. Thoma splint. Thoma splint. Next is Dennis Brown's. This is your
4th June.
Sir, save the screenshot. 4th June, 100% MCQ is going to come. Dennis Brown's splint that is used in CTEV or also club foot. That's in club foot. Your talus bones are now vertical to make them flat. We actually are using which splint? Dennis Brown's splint. So club foot or CTEV, mein kya use karoge? Kya use karoge? Yes, Dennis Brown's splint. This is your Dennis Brown's splint. Yeah. That's it. Dennis Brown's splint. Okay. Mermaid split. तो याद रखना मैं प्लेट की क्या होती है टांगें खुली रहती
हैं
ये कौन सी मेड खुली रहती है तो इसमें क्या करना है सर आपको टांगे छोड़ने की जरूरत नहीं है टांगे
नहीं टांगे ठीक है
क्या मतलब मर्मेड में क्या मर्मेड प्लेट का काम क्या होता काम काम क्या है उसका ये बताओ मर्मेड मेड का क्या टांगे भाई
जोड़ के रखनी है, खुली हुई टांग को जोड़ के रखनी है, बिल्कुल ठीक है। तो यात्रा मैरमेड स्प्रिंट दिस इज यूज्ड इन द रिकेट, मैरमेड स्प्रिंट इज यूज्ड इन द रिकेट, मैरमेड नो सर आप ट्राई करो। ओके
मैं नीचे का बनाऊंगा ऊपर का,
ठीक ठीक है
चलो। ये मैरमेड के ऐसे पैर होते हैं ना,
ठीक है
ऐसे मैरमेड, आई होप ऑल कैन सी द मैरमेड।
यस यस यस,
मैरमेड के ऊपर का बॉडी का हिस्सा थोड़ा सा ट्रिकी है, वहां पे ना वो ऐसे शेल्स लगा के रखती है, ठीक है। और फिर ये मरमेड का हेड है,
वाह 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 वाह।
सो ये हमारी मरमेड बनती है, ठीक है
ठीक है।
तो ऐसे पैर चिपके हुए ना ये
मरमेड, बिल्कुल ठीक है। तो मरमेड स्प्रिंट का काम है टांगों को जोड़ के रखना,
इसके लाने का कुछ है ही
बोलने नहीं देने, ठीक है। तो रिकेट्स में करते टांगे हट जाती है, इनको क्या करना है जोड़ के रखना, ठीक है। नेक्स्ट इज कॉक अप स्प्रिंट, ठीक है। कॉक अप स्प्रिंट गाइस रिमेंबर कॉक, वर्ड कॉक, इस अंगूठे को कॉक समझो, इस अंगूठे को कॉक समझो, ठीक है। और गाइस रिमेंबर दिस इज यूज्ड इन रेडियल नर्व इंजरी, इफ योर रेडियल नर्व इज गॉन। तो मैं पता नहीं क्या हुआ था बेबी बाबू सोना मोना को जब सुलाया था तुमने, तो तुम्हारा रिस्ट ड्रॉप हो गया था, फिर रेडियल नर्व इंजरी। गाइस रिमेंबर विच विच स्प्रिंट यू विल गिव, मेरे को एक भाई का फोन आएगा इनमें से कि सर नई नई गर्लफ्रेंड बनाई थी, यहाँ पे सुला दी, आपने मना करा था, मैंने फिर भी सुला दी, मेरा सुबह ऐसे हो गया, रिस्ट ड्रॉप हो गया, मैं क्या करूँ। तो मैं क्या बोलूंगा, कॉक अप, कॉक अप स्प्लिट, कॉक अप स्प्लिट, ठीक है। अनदर इमेज इज दिस, तुम्हारी आंख अर्जुन जैसी होनी चाहिए और तुम्हारा फोकस मित्रों सिर्फ यहाँ पे होना चाहिए, ठीक है। तो कॉक अप स्प्लिंट, ठीक है, इट इज यूज्ड इन रेडियल नर्व इंजरी। कॉक अप स्प्लिंट इज यूज्ड इन रेडियल नर्व इंजरी, रेडियल नर्व इंजरी। दिस वाज योर एफएमजी एग्जाम क्वेश्चन, एग्जैक्ट क्वेश्चन हैज बीन आस्क्ड इन द रीजन। ये इतनी खुश क्यों है,
इंजरी हो गई तो लड़कों को
लड़की है सर, खुश नहीं हो सकती, वो कुछ खुश नहीं हो सकती क्या, इसको खुश वो देखना, वो देखना दोबारा से आगे भाई। जो है देखो सर कॉक अप स्प्रिंट ऐसे पूरे ठीक है 2.5 किलो का हाथ, ठीक है। कॉक अप स्प्रिंट गाइस रिमेंबर, ओके चल चलो बहुत बड़े बहुत बड़े। नेक्स्ट इज नकल बेंडर, नेक्स्ट इज नकल बेंडर, नकल बेंडर इज यूज्ड इन द अल्नर नर्व इंजरी। गाइस रिमेंबर इन नकल बेंडर, व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन कॉक अप स्प्रिंट एंड नकल बेंडर। इन कॉक अप स्प्रिंट योर थंब इज आल्सो इन्वॉल्व इन दैट, thumb is also involved in that, but in knuckle bender which is actually used for the ulnar nerve injury, yes, your thumb is free, thumb can easily free, ठीक है, thumb can easily move freely move, right? In this also remember your thumb is outside the splint, that is your knuckle bender which is used for the ulnar nerve injury, which is used for the ulnar nerve injury। ये मेरा भाई aeroplane बन गया है, aeroplane splint PYQ recent exam question, this image was given, exactly the question was asked. And what was asked, aeroplane splint is used for the brachial plexus injury. Image-based question was asked, aeroplane splint mein kya ho gaya? Brachial plexus injury. Yes. Next, very, very, very important is your, idhar aao sir, important cheez aayi hai, to aap kahan ja rahe ho? Taylor splint check. Nahi, nahi, kuch check nahi karna, dekho. Taylor splint helps in the posture. Jo log zyada jhuk jate hain aage ki taraf, lordosis ho jati hai, theek hai? Unmein kya karna hai tumhe? टेलर स्प्रिंट देनी है। दोस्तों अब मैं जो मैं इमेज दिखाने वाला हूं, पहले प्रॉमिस करो कि तुम डिस्ट्रैक्ट नहीं हो गए,
नहीं
पहले मुझे नहीं पहले प्रॉमिस चाहिए कि डिस्ट्रैक्ट नहीं होना है, उसके बाद ही दिखाऊंगा। तुम्हारा फोकस सिर्फ स्प्रिंट पे होना चाहिए, सिर्फ स्प्रिंट पे होना चाहिए। आर यू ऑल प्रॉमिसिंग मी, आर यू प्रॉमिसिंग टेलर स्प्रिंट, जल्दी से टेलर स्प्रिंट जल्दी से बता दो भाई, क्या मैं तुम्हें भरोसा कर सकता हूँ, ठीक है ओके बोल दिया, ओके बोल दिया, ठीक है। स्कोलियोसिस में भी हो सकता है, ठीक है, लॉट ऑफ
एजिटी में लेकिन जाता बार बार
तुम्हारा एग्जाम है 4 तारीख, खबरदार खबरदार ऊपर करो अच्छी खबरदार, अगर कोई डिस्ट्रैक्ट हुआ तो सिर्फ फोकस होना चाहिए टेलर। और ये एग्जाम का क्वेश्चन था टेलर स्प्लिट, क्या है टेलर स्प्लिट,
कुछ देख
सर आपका भी ध्यान बिल्कुल नहीं भटकाना है, मैंने स्पेशली ये दिस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ प्रिपरेशन,
अर्जुन की आंख वाला
दिस इज, मैं जानबूझ के इमेज रखी है कि कल को इनको कोई भटकाने की कोशिश करेगी, मैं इनको इतनी ट्रेनिंग दे दूंगा कि कोई भी सुंदर कन्या या पुरुष किसी को डिस्ट्रैक्ट नहीं कर सकता, नहीं कर सकता, नहीं कर सकता। इनका सिर्फ और सिर्फ फोकस कहां होना चाहिए, ये जो ग्रे कलर का पार्ट
दिख रहा
है, ग्रे कलर का पार्ट दिख रहा है, उंगली डाल दोगे क्या अंदर, बिल्कुल So this is actually your Taylor splint. This is used in the posture correction in lordosis, scoliosis also. कुपड़े हो जाते हैं scoliosis mainly. Scoliosis mainly जो लोग कुपड़े हो जाते हैं उनको कुपड़ा सीधा करने के लिए ये splint use करी जाती है. Milwaukee brace, yes. Milwaukee brace is in scoliosis. This is mainly in the scoliosis. ठीक है? वो that is in the kyphosis. This is in the kyphosis. ठीक है? Taylor splint kyphosis, lordosis जो bend हो जाता है ना, that is kyphosis. ऊपर से बैठे kyphosis, नीचे से होएगा तो lordosis. इसके अंदर Taylor दी जाती है. But in the scoliosis, what is happening? S the shape of vertebra. In that, guys, remember very very high yield splint. काली चीजों पे ध्यान नहीं दिया देना है, सिर्फ और सिर्फ ये जो लेदर की बेल्ट है. दिस वाज योर नीट पीजी एंड एफएमजी एग्जाम क्वेश्चन, एफएमजी एग्जाम क्वेश्चन. एंड माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, तुम क्या डिस्ट्रैक्ट हो गए ऐसी चीजें देख के कि तुम सिर्फ पढ़ाई पर फोकस करोगे? मुझे जवाब चाहिए अभी के अभी, नंगे की चोट पे जवाब चाहिए. तो एग्जाम में कभी भी आ जाएगा क्या मिलवॉकी ब्रेस? क्या तुम 4 जून के पास एग्जाम में पास होने के बाद ऐसे पेशेंट्स को स्प्लिंट पहनाना चाहोगे कि नहीं पहनाना चाहोगे? क्या तुम इनको स्प्लिंट पहनाना चाहोगे कि नहीं पहनाना चाहोगे? क्या इसके लिए तुम मेहनत करने के लिए तैयार हो कि नहीं तैयार हो? अगर तुम 4 जून को पास हो जाते हो तो तुम्हें मौका मिलेगा साक्षात इनको स्प्लिंट पहना के इनको दर्दों से मुक्ति. ये क्या जूम कर रही डिस्ट्रैक्ट कर रहा हो? दर्दों से मुक्ति देनी है इनका जो ट्रीटमेंट करना है फॉर द डिजीज स्कोलियोसिस. आर यू ऑल रेडी एफएमजी? आर यू ऑल रेडी टू ट्रीट दिस पेशेंट?
यस.
Are you all ready to treat this patient? Before treating this patient, you all have to be very, very focused on your studies. No one can distract you. Yes, no one can distract you. We all are ready. Yes, sab log ready hain. Yes, sab log ready hain. Usse pehle kya hota? I will pass. 634 लोग रात को इसका इलाज करने के लिए रेडी है. यही हमारे एफएमजीज है जिनको लोग अंडर वो करते रेट करते हैं. इनका पता नहीं है ये क्या क्या कर सकते हैं, क्या क्या करके आए हैं, मुझे बताने की जरूरत नहीं है. मैंने दिलों तक की धड़कनों को पहचानता हूं. ठीक है, चलो चलो. नेक्स्ट इज ट्रैक्शन. यस, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द ट्रैक्शन. चलो ट्रैक्शन ट्रैक्शन. सबसे पहला है गैलो स्ट्रैक्शन. कौन सा ट्रैक्शन है? गैलो स्ट्रैक्शन. कुछ लोगों ने एल की जगह यहां डी कर दिया है. ठीक है, तो गाइस whenever this was exam question, देखो vulgarity की वजह से अगर हमारा एक नंबर आ जाता है क्या हमें vulgarity के पीछे जाना चाहिए कि नहीं जाना चाहिए? जल्दी बता दो मेरे साथियों जो रात को यहाँ बैठे हैं, क्या हमें जाना चाहिए कि नहीं जाना चाहिए? gallows traction, ये तरीके की जब traction आएगी, this is gallows traction. guys remember this is for the fracture of shaft of femur. shaft of femur. Yes, this is gallows traction, or it is also known as Bryant's traction. That is Bryant's traction. They all are ready to go after vulgarity to just get the 1 marks. So gallows traction or D, जो भी बोल रहे, please D मत बोलो, ये D बिल्कुल नहीं है. This is gallows traction. जब भी ऐसी इमेज आएगी तो याद रखना this is gallows, not वो D वाला. ठीक है, gallows traction, gallows traction. मेरे भाई ने बोला हक से वल्गर. यस, वी आर हक से वल्गर. कुछ लोग नाम बदल बदल के चैट में आते हैं, डिस्ट्रैक्ट करने की कोशिश करते हैं. क्या हम डिस्ट्रैक्ट होंगे? नहीं होंगे, नहीं होंगे, नहीं होंगे, नहीं होंगे. समझ में आया? यस यस यस. चलो नेक्स्ट इज रसल स्ट्रैक्शन. गाइस रिमेंबर रसल स्ट्रैक्शन ट्रोकियाट्रिक फ्रैक्चर. ट्रोकियाटा ग्रेटर ट्रोकियाट्रिक, लेसर ट्रोकियाट्रिक. गाइस रिमेंबर ट्रोकियाट्रिक फ्रैक्चर के अंदर रसल स्ट्रक्शन इज यूज्ड. दिस इज अ इमेज ऑफ रसल स्ट्रक्शन एंड दिस इज अ ट्रोकियाट्रिक फ्रैक्चर. ग्रेटर ट्रोकियाट्रिक एंड लेसर ट्रोकियाट्रिक फ्रैक्चर. डन 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 डन. ठीक है, चलो नेक्स्ट इज डन लूप ट्रैक्शन. डन लूप ट्रैक्शन इज सीन इन सुप्रा कोंडाइलर ह्यूमरस का फ्रैक्चर. व्हिच डिफॉर्मिटी सीन? कैन यू आंसर मी? Which deformity is seen? Can you answer me? Which deformity is seen in supracondylar fracture of the humerus? कुछ याद करो ऐसा वाला, कुछ ऐसा वाला याद करो. कौन सा वाला था? जल्दी जल्दी जल्दी. Gangster, kya baat hai? You all are going to pass on 4th of June. Yes, my dear, this is my promise. Tumhe sab yaad ho raha hai. This is the first sign of positivity towards your passing of the exam. Allah bol, exam pass. Then no protection. Next, the last topic. Yes, my dear friend, last topic. We are still having 9 minutes. Last topic, guys. Remember, last topic, tumors. Yes. Number one tumor is osteoid osteoma. Osteoid osteoma, most common for the proximal femur. Most common involvement is the proximal femur. Osteoid osteoma is a benign tumor. It is never malignant, and you can see here. Can you appreciate this thing? This is osteoid osteoma. And also this image, you can see this is benign tumor, that is osteoid osteoma, and the most common bone involvement is proximal part of the femur. Proximal part of the femur. Proximal part of the femur. Okay? Chalo. Thank you so much. Next is giant cell tumor. Neet PG and FMG exam question. Giant cell tumor. Guys, remember, lytic. Lytic matlab breakdown. Lytic lesion without sclerotic mark. Sclerotic matlab hardening. Sclerotic matlab hardening. Lytic matlab kya hai? Breakdown. Lytic lesion without sclerotic margin involving the articular surface. This is none other than giant cell tumor. Recent Neet PG exam question and FMG exam also, this has been asked at least four times. Okay. Nishant Jha has got MS Orthopaedics in Neet PG 21. Congratulations. Giant cell tumor, the second tumor, and the third is your aneurysmal bone cyst. Actually, there is a cyst formation, but the bone continuity is not. And on the bone, there is a cyst covering. This is known as aneurysmal bone cyst. Never ever confuse aneurysmal bone cyst with the giant cell tumor. Giant cell tumor is actually a lytic lesion that are breaking down without sclerotic margin on the articular surface, and aneurysmal cyst is a cyst which is actually covering the bone. Cyst is always looking like a gray, something gray in between. Okay, so this is a cyst, and you can appreciate a bone also present. This is aneurysmal bone cyst. Never ever confuse it with a giant cell tumor. This is an image of giant cell tumor. Whenever it is coming in your exam, itna bada case hoga. Just read the last line. What is the diagnosis? Just mark the answer, and the game is done. And you all are going to pass. You all are going to pass. Okay, chal. Aneurysmal bone cyst, Ewing sarcoma. Oh my god, 169%. 4th of June. Ewing sarcoma mein cases are given. This much cases are given, but the only thing you have to remember, what you have to remember, my dear, onion peel appearance. Yes. My question to you, onion peel appearance is seen in FMG sector. You just need to know onion peel appearance is seen. Your answer is onion peel appearance is seen in. Onion peel appearance is seen in. My difference, onion peel appearance is seen in Ewing sarcoma. That is seen in Ewing sarcoma. Next is osteosarcoma. Osteosarcoma has been repeated 4 times PYQ. One time in Neet PG and 3 to 4 times in the FMG exam. Two things you have to remember: sunburst appearance. Number one MCQ. Yes, my dear. Number one MCQ is sunburst appearance, and number two is odd man's triangle. Sunburst appearance. This is sunburst appearance. See again. This is a cord man's triangle. These are the features of osteosarcoma. And this is seen after the periosteal reaction. Can you tell me which collagen fibers are present in periosteum? Your answer is correct. That is type 1 collagen, and this is also an image which has been, exact image has been asked in the Neet PG and FMG, because NB is the only body which is deciding paper for both FMG and Neet PG. This is sun ray appearance or sunburst appearance. Can you tell me where it is seen? Which disease you will actually think of just by looking at this x-ray, it is osteosarcoma. We have completed all of the orthopedics with all the high yield content, all thanks to our orthopedician faculty of LNC, Dr. Nitin Bhagat sir, for the notes, and also supervised by our beloved faculty, Dr. Ashish sir.
Yes,
guided me all the time. Guys, remember, now what we have to do. Humne sara padh liya. This is what we have to do in the daily practice also. Now, in the next 10 minutes, we are going to revise all the orthopedics. Are you all with me? I'll ask you the question. I'll ask you the images. You have to answer. Are you all ready? Yes. 3, 2, 1, start. Yes. Now, what is this? Can you tell me what is this? You all have to answer. Please answer. First of all, answer. Please. Abhi khatam nahi hua mamla. Abhi to yaad karake chhodunga. Sapno mein bhi aayega. Kya bolenge? Sapno mein milta hai. Ye aneurysmal bone system mujhe sapno mein milta hai. Sari raat judi ho main nang bade de me. Theek hai, aneurysmal bone system. Next is your onion peel appearance is seen in. Next question to you. Onion peel appearance is seen in Ewing sarcoma. Perfect. Lytic lesion without sclerotic margin involving the articular surface. What is your diagnosis? This is your diagnosis is Chanting, GTC. Next question. बताने की ज़रूरत नहीं है, देखते ही पता लग जाएगा. Which traction is this? I want all of you to answer. Which traction is this? GALLOWS. Gallows traction. This is your gallows traction. Next important thing you need to answer, what is this? Which splint is this? Isko treat karna tha hame pass hone ke baad. Bhul gayi ki yaad hai ki nahi hai. Which splint is this? Please jaldi se which splint is this? Jaldi se answer karo. Which splint is this? Iske saath milke chalna chahte ho ki nahi chalna chahte ho? Milwaukee, pata hai inko, sab pata hai. Milwaukee is used to treat the scoliosis. Which splint is this? Can you all answer me? Which splint is this? Jaldi se. Ye dekho bhai ka kya ban gaya? Jahaj ban gaya. Ye brachial plexus injury mein use hota hai. Can you all tell me? Brachial plexus injury mein use hota hai. Jaldi se bata do. This is aeroplane splint. Now your thumb is actually out from the splint. Which splint is this? This is knuckle bender, which is used for the ulnar nerve ka injury. Ye dekho. Isko dekhte hi kuch up ho jata hai. And this splint is used in the radial nerve ka injury. Wow. And this splint is known as cock up splint. This is Dennis Brown splint used in the treatment of. Dennis Brown splint is used in the treatment CTEV or club foot. CTEV or club foot. This is which splint? It is used in the fracture of femur, shaft of femur. Which splint is used? Which splint? This is Thomas splint. Okay, femur. Chal. This you already answered. Chalo. Next, I want to ask you about the Hill Sachs lesion is seen in the glenoid labrum or bone. Hill Sachs lesion is seen in the posterior part of the head of humerus. Yes. Hill Sachs lesion is seen in the posterior part of head of humerus as compared to the Bankard lesion, which is avulsion in the glenoid labrum. Glenoid labrum, and that is happening because of shoulder dislocation. What is the most common side of shoulder dislocation? Your answer is anterior side. This already asked you. All the fracture has been asked. Which deformity is this? So The person is falling onto this hand. Which fracture is this? What is your diagnosis? The first thing coming to your mind, and on X-ray you will see Gardner's shape deformity. This is a fracture of distal and of radius with the displacement which is opposite to the pollicis. This is none other than Smith fracture. This is none other than Smith fracture. Smith fracture. Neck of humerus ke fracture ke under which nerve is gone? Neck of humerus ke fracture mein which nerve is gone? Neck of humerus ke fracture mein which nerve is gone? That is your axillary nerve. Axillary nerve. On the shaft of humerus, which nerve is gone? On the shaft of humerus where your baby was sleeping, on the shaft of humerus, which nerve is gone? Your answer is radial nerve. Radial nerve. Radial nerve. And the treatment of the radial nerve injury, which splint you were giving? Cock up splint. Which splint? Cock up splint. Okay? These are the complication of fracture. In the early complication, we have studied about the number one shock. Neuralgic shock or hypovolemic shock. Number second thing is fat embolism. Number third is compartment syndrome. There is a painful dorsiflexion of the hand where you will encounter with the Wachmann ischemia. Wachmann ischemia, that is a highly painful condition because of negative pressure in the fascia. And in the treatment, you were doing urgent fasciotomy. Urgent fasciotomy. Chalo, ye hilata hun to batana kya hai. Na. Ye kaun sa hai? Jaldi se batao. Which fracture is this? Yes, which fracture is this? Multiple fragments are broken down. Which fracture is this? Jaldi se batao. Which fracture is this? Yes, my dear friend, you all are correct. This is your comminuted fracture. Let's talk about the syndrome and the nerve involved. Very, very simple. In the cubital tunnel syndrome, the nerve involved is the ulnar nerve. In the Guyon canal syndrome, the nerve involved is the ulnar nerve. Cubital Guyon's. In the carpal tunnel, tunnel is always in the middle. Tunnel hamesha beecho beech hoti hai, chahe pahadon mein ho, chahe kahin bhi ho. So yaad rakhna, median nerve injury. Median nerve injury. Let's talk about the most common dislocation. Shoulder, most common dislocation. Anterior dislocation. Elbow, posterior. Hip, posterior. Knee, anterior. Patella, la. Lateral dislocation. Bursitis, if I talk about. Housemaid's knee, pre-patellar bursitis, clergyman's knee, infrapatellar bursitis, student's elbow, that was your Fmge exam question, that is polycranon bursitis, weaver's bottom, ischial bursitis, Taylor's bottom, la, lateral bursitis, that is your lateral bursitis. Which gene is involved in the ankylosing spondylitis? Your answer is HLA-B27. And on X-ray, which appearance you are going to see? Your answer is bamboo spine. Bamboo spine you will see. This is Brody's absence and most common organism responsible for the body's absence when the bone is replaced by a pus, that is your staph aureus. That is staph aureus. In the chronic osteomyelitis, the new bone formation is known as involucrum and the dead bone formation is known as sequestrum. That is known as sequestrum. Acute osteomyelitis is most commonly seen with the children. Acute osteomyelitis is seen with the children. Children are acute, that is why acute is seen in children. And which part is most commonly involved? That is your metaphysis. Why metaphysis? Because most common spread is heterogeneous spread by which organism? Your answer is staph aureus. This is champion glass appearance. This is seen in achondroplasia FMG exam question. Champion glass pelvis is seen in achondroplasia, and along with this trident hand, which actually looks like starfish, these are also feature of achondroplasia. In the achondroplasia, your limbs are normal. The limbs are short, but the trunk is normal. Limbs are short, but the limb is normal. Next thing is your cotton wool skull is seen in. Cotton wool skull is seen in Paget's disease. In which stage of Paget's disease? Your answer is mixed stage of Paget's disease, where the bone formation and the bone breakdown is occurring simultaneously. Without even looking at anything, just focus and remember the three things. Number one thing is hearing loss, that is sensorineural hearing loss. Then another thing is blue sclera. Third thing is multiple bone fracture. This type is 100% MCQ of NEET PG and FMG exam. Your answer is osteo genesis imperfecta. Osteogenesis imperfecta. That is your osteogenesis imperfecta. This is marble bone disease where the bone intensity is highly increased. That is also a cause of easily fractured bone. Easily fractured bone. This is the fish mouth vertebra or cod fish vertebra. Cod fish mouth vertebra is seen in which disease? Your answer is osteoporosis. Codfish or fish mouth vertebra was asked in Neet PG and FMG exam. Another thing is your loser zone. Loser zone is seen in which disease? Your answer is osteomalacia. Malacia. There is a loser zone present which actually looks like a pseudo fracture. But the intensity, normal intensity of bone is present, but the looser zone is present, which actually look like a fracture, but it is not at all a fracture. This is known as osteomalacia. Sharpest fibers connect periosteum to the bone. Sharpest fibers connect periosteum to the bone, and the outer covering of the bone is known as periosteum. Congratulations, you are getting 4 to 5 marks on 4th of June. Yes. In just 2 hours. You all are going to pass on 4th of June, and you all have to say, I will pass. Dandana, 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 duck. Orthopedic khatam. Now, Dr. Ritesh will post 10 MCQ in the integrated learning channel group. Please solve. Those are the question, exact question asked in the Neet PG and FMG, and see how many questions you would be easily going to solve just reading with the focus, with all the fun for the 2 hours. Never stress out. Never stress out. We are there for you.
Yes.
Jab hum baithe hain to chinta ki kya baat, banayenge aise aise nahi. निमोनिक कि 4 जून को हो जाएगी नहीं आप पास बोलो आई विल पास लव यू ऑल ठीक है. एंड आल्सो गाइस रिमेंबर ऑन द 1st ऑफ अप्रैल रेगुलर ऑनलाइन एंड ऑफलाइन चैंटिंग प्लस रिवीजन batch we are going to launch in LNC online and offline platform. Online and offline platform from the 1st of April. Do not waste a single day, guys. There in LNC app, we are going to take all the chanting session, all the revision sessions, all the tests, everything. So 922 people actually voted for the answer. So actually, today approximately 900 to 1000 people came for chanting.
That's great.
And some people even watch later, their timing doesn't match. Yes. But all we have to do is continuously study. And please, if any query, please, if you want to join this rapid revision batch, please query. I want to give you number.
Ukraine hybrid batch
is also there. You can actually contact this number. Yes. NLC query.
Yes.
Guys, remember, this is your 78277528555. Okay? And for me, P Jamwal 7 Instagram. You can connect me there. Dr. Ashish.
Yes.
Next Instagram. You can connect us on Instagram, and for any queries related to any batch, you can contact NLC on this number. Rest, I think we both have made some path easy for you guys. It is a collective effort. It is a demand and supply. You guys are listening. That's why we are speaking. Otherwise, no fun. More the people you are interested, more efforts we will make to make ensure that you are going to pass on 4th of June. Yes. 4 June ke baad duniya tumko bolegi doctor saab wo feel yaad karo ki ye doctor ke papa ja rahe hain, doctor ki mummy ja rahi hai.
Yes.
Kaisi feeling aayegi dosto?
Doctor ka boyfriend hai
ek prabhu dekh kya hi bol. Guys, please, if any query, we can still talk. Tum samne khana nahi khaya, I know. But these sacrifices in the end will pay you off with the title doctor. Mere liye to tum abhi doctor ho. Main to FMG hoon, sir ke liye tum abhi doctor. ठीक है, हमें पता तुम डॉक्टर बन गए, बस लोगों को भी तो दिखाना है ना एक बार पास करके एग्जाम। उस पास होने के लिए आपको बहुत ज्यादा मेहनत कर ली दोस्तों, बीच में बहुत सारे लोग आएंगे, इवन इन द चैट पीपल केम, दे यूज टू मॉक मी सर दिस दैट, डजंट मैटर गाइस, एग्जाम मैटर एंड पासिंग मैटर्स। पास हो जाओगे, मजे करोगे, मम्मी पापा को इतना अच्छा लगेगा, जो उन्होंने लाइफ टाइम इन्वेस्टमेंट करी ना, जो जुआ खेला आपके ऊपर, आपको बाहर भेजा, पढ़ाया, पैसे लगाए कि ये कल को हमें एक टाइटल देंगे डॉक्टर के पापा डॉक्टर की मम्मी, वो डॉक्टर के पापा और डॉक्टर की मम्मी। अब टाइम आ चुका है, आपने कभी भी बाहर से फोन, इवन आई वॉज स्टूडेंट, ठीक है, आई वॉज स्टूडेंट इन चाइना, हमने कभी भी पेरेंट्स को फोन करा, नो मैटर उनके पास पैसे थे या नहीं थे, उन्होंने हमेशा भेजे। क्या हमारा फर्ज नहीं बनता उनको खुशियां देनी, जल्दी से जल्दी कमाना शुरू करें, अपने मम्मी पापा को पैसे भेजना शुरू करें, उनको बोलो अब मम्मी पापा आपने बहुत मेहनत कर ली, अभी आप बैठो मैं आपकी सेवा करूंगा या करूंगी, प्लीज मुझे मौका दो। क्या आप चाहते हो, नहीं चाहते हो ऐसा? क्या आप उनकी खुशी के लिए आने वाले 70-75 दिनों तक कुछ सेक्रीफाइस नहीं कर सकते? बिल्कुल कर सकते हो। प्लीज गाइस स्टे फोकस्ड, स्टडी हार्ड, यू ऑल आर गोइंग टू पास, यू ऑल आर गोइंग टू पास, लव यू ऑल, लव यू ऑल, लव यू ऑल, ठीक है, चल अब हम अलविदा लेंगे, ठीक है, चल डन डना डन डना डन, ठीक है,
चलो बाय बाय, टेक केयर,
ओके, वीर तुम बड़े चलो, वीर तुम बड़े चलो, सामने पहाड़ हो सिंह की दहाड़, तुम निडर रुको नहीं, तुम निडर डटे रहो, वीर तुम बड़े चलो, वीर तुम बड़े चलो, लव यू ऑल, लव यू ऑल, लव यू ऑल, लव यू ऑल, dan 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 I will pass, पढ़ते चलो, बोलो आई विल पास, भैया आई विल पास, मुझे नहीं कोई रोकेगा, आई विल पास, मैं दिन रात पढ़ूंगा, आई विल पास, और मैं तुम्हें चैंटिंग कराऊंगा, बिकॉज यू विल पास, बोलो यू विल पास, आपकी बार दो सौ बार, कितना मजा आ रहा सुनने, आपकी बार दो सौ बार, भैया आई विल पास, भैया आई विल पास, आपकी बार दो सौ बार, आई विल पास, 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 लव यू, लव यू, लव यू, चलो बाय बाय, बाय बाय, गुड नाइट, दस विधानिया स्पाका नोची जो भी होता है ना, चलो चलो सर कर दो बंद, बंद कर दो।